My 13-year-old acts like a puppy again. Almost overnight, she's a different dog.
Perfect poops.
When people switch their dog's food to the farmer's dog, the effects can seem like magic. But there's no magic involved. It's simply real meat and vegetables with all the nutrients dogs need instead of highly processed pellets. No tricks, just smarter, healthier pet food delivered in packs portioned for your dog. It's amazing what real food can do. Get 50% off your first order at thefarmersdog.com/nomagic.
From executive producer Jimmy Kimmel.
What's up, team? Just two people can't launch a brand. It takes a village.
We are MMD Hollywood.
Wowee.
Which stands for medical marijuana.
Due to restrictions, we can't tell you everything about our new reality series. But what we can say is the idea behind it is fully baked. High Hopes. Streaming 420 on Hulu.
Listening to your favorite podcast? That's smart. Earning your degree online from Southern New Hampshire University? That's really smart. With 24/7 access to coursework, no set class times, and dedicated student support, you can go to school when and where it works for you. Low online tuition means you can even do it for less. And dedicated student support means we'll be with you from day one to graduation and beyond. Join a community of learners just like you. Go to snhu.edu today to start your free application.
What's up? It's your boy, The Ted Smith from The Men's Room. And did you know I have a podcast? Well, I do. The Podcast. New episodes uploaded every Wednesday on the Odyssey app.
Unfortunately, what you're about to hear is real. The members of this radio program are simply not that bright, or what some people would call educated. They are merely stupid. They're not trying to offend anyone on purpose. And all have played doctors on TV. You have been warned and are cordially invited to join the party. This is the Men's Room.
Forget it, man, and get with the countdown. Get with the countdown. Shake this square world and blast off for Kicksville. Kicksville. The trippers, the grasshoppers, the hip ones, all gathered in secrecy and flying high as a kite.
This is the Men's Room with Miles and Thrill. You know what they say, shake your radio more than three times, and you're playing with it. You're listening to the Men's Room.
And away we go. Welcome to season 19, episode number 4063. Along with Steve the Thrill Hill, the Ted Smith,
woo!
And Mike Hawk. Montgomery! And you are in the Men's Room. On tap today, Taryn Daly from the Daily Migs Morning Show joins us, and once again, we will sit and spin. And today, the absolute worst, with the 10 worst lyrics in classic rock. We will play Profile This, plus headlines, a Men's Room shout of the day, fundable listener emails, and everyone's favorite, TV Time with T.
Click, clack.
Gringity drum.
All right, here we go. Robber steals 600 Venus flytraps in North Carolina, bringing a WKRP DJ to tears. Meanwhile, a woman is arrested for DUI with two 14-year-olds who'd also had a few beers. Man stuck in airplane bathroom sees the pilot help to open the door. Because of a train, a sex offender in Eugene, Oregon is no more. And a drunk Indiana woman lets two 12-year-olds drive her car at 1 a.m. because she was hammered. That is all coming on today's very special episode of The Men's Room.
And now, here's the question.
Hola, bitches. Good day to you and yours. All right, some people, like my wife, just naturally wake up early to get a start on their day. Others wake up to an alarm or a crying baby. Maybe you wake up to construction. I pretty much wake up every day to my dog jumping on the bed and licking my bald head until I just finally get up. Now, it's not my favorite thing, but it is a better scenario than the guy that was, well, jolted awake in Las Vegas. You see, he was woken up because, well, frankly, a scorpion stung his testicles. Now, no one knows how the scorpion got there. But it got there, and it zapped his ghoulies. Now, here's the thing. It could always be worse. A man in New York City, that makes me giggle, and it shouldn't. He fell asleep on the subway, and he woke up with a stranger's hand in his pants.
Mm.
It should be noted, the hand was attached to the human being. It was not severed or anything. Guy was doing what you think he was doing. Now, I don't say this much, but I think I'd rather wake up to the scorpion. Not to be outdone, a man in upstate New York, he woke up, well, because his bed was on fire. Turns out he suffered burns to his lower legs. He lost his entire house, but I guess the silver lining is he did manage to escape with his life. Same goes for a woman in Lake Tahoe. She woke up to someone rummaging through her kitchen. Only it wasn't a person. It was a bear. And then the bear messed her up pretty badly. Like I said, I just wake up to my dog licking my head. But today we're talking about those times that something out of the ordinary or unexpected woke you up. Not necessarily a bad thing, but probably not a good thing. But this is today's question, fill in the blank style. I once woke up and blank was going on.
To be a part of the Big Show, call 206-803-ROCK. You can like the Men's Room on Facebook, follow us on Twitter and Instagram at Men's Room Live, and send your emails to themensroom@kisw.com.
My 13-year-old acts like a puppy again. Almost overnight, she's a different dog.
Perfect poops.
When people switch their dog's food to the farmer's dog, the effects can seem like magic. But there's no magic involved. It's simply real meat and vegetables with all the nutrients dogs need instead of highly processed pellets. No tricks, just smarter, healthier pet food delivered in packs portioned for your dog. It's amazing what real food can do. Get 50% off your first order at thefarmersdog.com/nomagic.
From executive producer Jimmy Kimmel.
What's up, team? Just two people can't launch a brand. It takes a village.
We are MMD Hollywood.
Wowee.
Which stands for medical marijuana.
Due to restrictions, we can't tell you everything about our new reality series. But what we can say is the idea behind it is fully baked.
I don't know.
High Hopes. Streaming 420 on Hulu.
Listening to your favorite podcast? That's smart. Earning your degree online from Southern New Hampshire University? That's really smart. With 24/7 access to coursework, no set class times, and dedicated student support, you can go to school when and where it works for you. Low online tuition means you can even do it for less. And dedicated student support means we'll be with you from day one to graduation and beyond. Join a community of learners just like you. Go to snhu.edu today to start your free application.
Reaching your financial goals is so much easier with MilliBank. With our customizable jars, put your money directly toward your savings goals, keeping them in sight and on track. Plus, with our highly competitive annual percentage yield and no fees or minimums, your money will grow faster with complete transparency. So whether it's a much-needed vacation, a passion project, or building an emergency fund, save more for the things that matter most with MilliBank. Get started by visiting milli.bank. Or download the Millie app today.
The debauchery rolls on. You're listening to The Men's Room with Miles and Thrill. 99.9 KISW.
Oh, but y'all, away we go. Welcome to season 19, episode number 4063. What a large and in charge program we have for you today. Guaranteed future repeat. As once again, we'll be joined by the lovely Taryn Daly from the Daily Migs Morning Show. And we will sit and spin. And today, we feature lyrics that either don't make any sense just based on the premise. Maybe it's the wording that is absolutely bizarre, but we have the 10 worst lyrics in classic rock coming up for you today.
Sometimes you got to force a rhyme. You just got to force a rhyme sometimes, right?
Well, you know, ultimately, the list came, there were 50 songs.
All right.
So there's stuff on there like 23's Cherry Pie from Warrant. Just everything from cheesy to things that don't make any logical sense to
right.
things that just rhyme, that are just stupid, that are meaningless. These are the 10 worst lyrics in classic rock coming up as we will sit and spin. What else do we have for you today? Oh, yes, exciting news. As we've launched the Men's Room IPA from Black Raven Brewing, we invite you, if you happen to find the beer out there, to shoot us an email to themensroom@kisw.com. We'll try to get as many of the locations to you out as possible.
Do we have the locations on the website?
I've got a pretty big list. I'm going to try to read as many as I can today after emails.
All right. Because somebody asked yesterday, they said, where can I find the locations? And my exact response was, it might be on our website. I honestly don't know.
I'll tell you one thing that is on our website in the Rock Shop, the brand new Men's Room IPA Black Raven Brewing t-shirts.
Thank you, VD, for letting us know.
They are on sale right now at KISW.com. We hope you can join us for the Men's Room World Tour 2024, stop number one. That would be the Men's Room IPA launch party happening at the Black Raven Brewery and Tap House in Woodinville. That goes down Friday, March the 15th. We will do our show live from 2 to 6. Hopefully get a chance to stop by and taste the brand new Men's Room IPA. So far, Only good things have been said.
So far, yeah.
So that is awesome news. And if you haven't got a chance to find the beer or taste the beer, join us on Friday, the March 15th at the Black Raven Brewery and Tap House in Woodville. They got tons of great beer up there. That is a wonderful beer hall.
It is.
And we're going to do our show live.
It's so a Friday going into St. Patrick's Day weekend. That's a fun way to get it going.
And look, man, St. Paddy's Day is Sunday. So before you even call out of work on Monday because you're not feeling well, maybe just join us on the 15th. Get it started, right?
Yeah, do an afternooner. 2 till 6, we'll do the show live from there and hope to see your faces. But the Black Raven Brewery and Tap House in Woodinville, again, Friday, March 15th, from 2 until 6. Okay, today on The Question, we're going to talk about sleeping. Sleeping is a wonderful thing. Sometimes you have a restless night's sleep for whatever reason. Sometimes you have just some messed up dreams or whatever the deal is. It might wake you up in the middle of the night. That fart that turns into maybe a little bit more where you need to get up and go to the bathroom.
Or the fart that just smells so bad that you actually wake up because you farted under the cover.
If you live where I do, the sound of sirens, the sound of garbage trucks, which in my neighborhood only drive in reverse, which is impressive because you got to be a pretty good driver to do that everywhere. They do it on multiple days. Of course, I've got construction behind me that just finished up just in time for them to blow another building down and start construction once again.
It is amazing how it works, man. They've been working on the light rail basically at the end of my driveway for 3, 4, 5 years, whatever. Most of the heavy stuff is done, so we were very happy about that. And a lot of times, you know, because it's right next to I-5, so it's like, okay, well, we're going to close your exit at 11 p.m. and reopen it at 5 a.m., which means to me it's going to be loud as F at our house between 11 p.m. and 5 a.m. So they finished most of that stuff. I'm like, cool, good, thank you. Well, remember the tree fell down in my yard last May, late April, whatever it was. Well, that plot of land, they're now building 2 townhomes directly outside of the bedroom
window.
Good
news, it's only 2.
It's only 2, but they start at 7 a.m., and they start at 7 a.m. sharp. But hey, on the weekends, thanks to the new noise ordinance, they wait until 8 a.m. And I was thinking,
but they also pull up at 6:45 and just kind of hang out.
Dude,
it's amazing.
They get out of the car, they're blaring the radio, you hear their conversations, and apparently they must yell at each other. Because I'll look out the bedroom window like, dude, you are literally standing 4 feet away from this guy. But hey, baby, we got a big day today, baby. Putting on the roof. Like, are you trying to tell me or are you telling the guy you're looking at? My God, man.
Yep. If you have pets, they'll wake you up in the middle of the night. Cats sometimes don't want to go to bed. A dog fart can wake you up. There's all kinds of unexpected things. If you've had children that, I don't feel well, my tummy hurts.
Now it's my problem.
There's all kinds of ways.
Here's the one that pissed me off with my kids because you knew exactly how it was going to shake out. Look, I'm here for you. I understand. Yes, you walk into the bedroom, but the one, and they don't do it now, but when they're younger, it's the dad, dad. That, or actually, my daughter would just lift my eyelids for me. I didn't put any effort in. She just took her fingers and opened my eyes, and I can't sleep. These are the words that come out of their mouth. Just climb into bed with me, man. Come on. Within 2 minutes, they are dead asleep, and now I'm awake for the next hour and a half.
Yep.
Every single time. Because my daughter would climb into bed, and she apparently has kung fu dreams. So she'd fall asleep in 2 minutes, even though she can't sleep. But then I'm getting kicked in the face. You're getting hit in just everything. And then my son would be a mouth breather. And he'd always lay on my pillow facing me. And I'm sorry, in the middle of the night, nobody's breath is good. I almost wanted to take like a Tic Tac and stick it on his tongue. But you go through it. And again, you can't sleep. But here you are dead asleep. And my ass is awake, and you're next to me. And I'm sweating out because you're hot-ass body. Right. I'm like, this is ridiculous.
Told this story many times. I'm 6 years old, and I went and told my stepfather, I said, there's something in my room. There's something flying around in my room. And he's like, well, what do you think it is? I said, I think it's a bat. It's not very big, but it's flying around in my room. Right. I said, it's too big to be a moth. I know it's not a moth, and I can hear it when it flaps. I had a little nightlight that plugged into an outlet. But other than that, because I needed a light at that point in time to go to bed.
Sure.
Because I was a kid, you know, so I couldn't sleep in the dark.
Candy is.
But either way, I could see the shadows, and I could hear the floop, 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 floop.
Yeah.
So I went in, woke my stepfather up and said, hey, there's something, you know, flying around in my room. And he's, okay. So he gets up, comes in my room. Of course, when he comes in my room, bat's gone. There's nothing flying around in my room. Because he flips on the light switch. And looks around. He's like,
how old are you?
I'm 6. He's like,
oh, yeah.
He's like, all right, listen, everything's fine. There's nothing in your room. Just go to bed, whatever. Okay. So I'm kind of freaked out. And for about an hour after he left, or however long it was, I finally calmed down enough to go to bed. Mm-hmm. And I fell asleep. And apparently he came back to check a couple hours later because at that point in time,
I wake up, and he is in my room, and he has got my wiffle ball bat, my yellow long wiffle ball bat, like a fungo bat, but plastic.
The standard and wiffle ball bat.
I woke up to
him. I'm just swinging and missing on the thing.
So, and the light's on, and but the bat's flying around, all right?
Is that bat on bat violence?
Well, I guess so. So I...
one's yellow.
I, in my wisdom, got underneath my comforter at that time, and I remember exactly what the comforter was. It was a NASCAR slash drag racing slash,
right,
you know, Indy 500 slash, it was a racing blanket. And I got under it, and I covered my head up because I was terrified, right? And then he goes, hold on, I'll be right back. So he goes, he played tennis at the time, and he goes downstairs to, like, the closet or whatever and grabs his tennis racket. This is an old-school wooden Wilson Spalding, whatever, mm-hmm. an old-school tennis racket. And he comes up, and, like, I mean, seriously, in one shot, thump, and then the bat basically hits the wall, drops on the floor. He takes the tennis racket and pins the bat down and holds the bat, and eventually... he was able to open up one of my windows, which were pretty well painted shut on this old house anyway. Opens up the window. It is able to basically pick the bat up with the racket and throw the thing out the window. So that's how we got rid of the bat. But that was one of the weirdest things to wake up to, at least my childhood, that I can remember.
Sure. I think...
But to have something alive in your room that's not a pet is a little bit
weird. Yeah, it's going to be a little disconcerting. I think the weirdest thing I woke up to, and I was in my late 20s, I'm living in New Orleans... and the apartment I had was above a bar. And I had to get up early because the restaurant I worked in, Commander's Palace. So I had to get up by 6. I can't remember what time I had to be there, but you had to be there early. Whatever. So I'm kind of getting out of bed, but I swear I hear something in my apartment. But I don't really see anything at first because it's kind of pitch black. Then my door pops open. The front door to my place pops open. And keep in mind, I used to sleep naked at this time. So I'm standing in my apartment, butt-ass naked, trying to figure out what this sound is. The door flies open. Like 6 cops, they come bursting in, they have flashlights, but they don't see me at first, so they kind of slow down. Then I go, hey, all these guys jump, now I got guns trained on me, all the flashlights on me, and I got my hands in front of my junk, which is part of the story. The guy goes, put your hands up. I said, no, I said, dude, I'm naked. I don't have any, why are you here? Long story short, the bar that was on the bottom floor of my apartment building, the silent alarm was set off. So they assumed somebody robbed it. Maybe they did. Maybe they didn't. I don't know. But they came up the stairs to check. They burst into my place. And I'm having this conversation with, well, I'm naked. They still have their guns on me. They're starting to believe me, but they're not quite sure. Then I see them flip around and they're aiming their guns down the stairs that lead up to my place. And I can't quite see what's going on. But I hear this familiar voice of one of the guys who worked at the bar downstairs but lived across the hall from me. And this guy looked exactly like Kid Rock. I cannot emphasize that enough. Looked exactly like Kid Rock. He is hammered. So he's stumbling up the stairs. The cops keep screaming, dude, stay right there. Stop walking up the stairs. While he's drunk. F you, man. I'm just trying to go home kind of thing going on. So I have to race out there. Keep in mind, I'm naked the whole time. So I got 6 cops, my naked ass, and Kid Rock walking up the stairs. And I'm like, guys, I know him. He did not rob the bar. He works at the bar downstairs. Please do not shoot him. Obviously, they did not. But he gets to the top of the stairs, and because he's hammered, he walks into my apartment. He's directly across the hall. He walks into my apartment and passes out on my couch. And I'm like, you've got to be kidding me, man. So the cops kind of figure all this thing out. We talk for a second. I say, guys, I'm not trying to be difficult. I really want to get dressed because this has been uncomfortable. They agreed. It was a little strange. And I said, I got to go to work. They go, what are you going to do basically with Kid Rock here? So just let his dumb ass sleep on my couch. Like, I'm dumb with this. I just want to get out of bed and take a shower. Now I don't have time to take a shower. I'm stinking. I go into work. Work my day, whatever. When I get home, Kid Rock is no longer in my apartment. But I see him later. And I'm like, how'd you do last night? He's like, did we party last night, man? Like, I woke up on your couch. I'm like, you don't remember anything about last night. He's like, no. I said, dude, the cops almost gunned you down in the stairwell. And my naked ass had to prevent them from shooting you. All I wanted to do was get out of bed. I woke up to this.
Yes.
Thank you. Turns out he's the guy that set off the silent alarm because he got hammered down there. And just however he chose to leave the bar, he did it.
Right.
That was the whole thing.
Or did he just forget?
I don't.
Man, I worked at a couple different bars. There was one bar where it was like you drink after work, but you knew you had to be out by a certain time.
Yeah.
And then there was another bar where we could drink in one section and you could walk out.
this bar.
Oh, as far as the cameras not being on you or something?
Or they just were like where the alarms were or whatever. I just remember it was like, all right, we could sit right here. But like you couldn't have, if you started, if you went to play, if you got drunk and forgot and went to play pool.
It would start off the alarm.
Yes.
This guy, I mean, like this bar is kind of loose with the rules. Like says, but he's a pretty good bartender. But I'm just like, bro, you got to get it together, man. I almost got shot naked in my home.
Well, the inspiration for our question today, we go to Las Vegas. A California man staying at the Las Vegas Strip Resort over the holiday season said he was considering legal action after he said his testicles were stung by a scorpion while he was asleep. Michael Farchi of Agora Hills said he woke up in excruciating pain during his stay at the resort. I just felt like someone stabbed me in my privates. It felt like a sharp glass or a knife. I went into the bathroom and saw a scorpion hanging from my underwear. The man and his family.
That's Klaus Main.
The man and his family checked out early one day later, December 27th. The hotel did comp his room. He and his attorney shared
a
photo.
That's a deal. Hey, if you get stung in the testicles by a scorpion, it's on us.
Of the orange scorpion on his underwear. When asked if he knew how the scorpion got into his hotel room, the California man, he had no idea. I didn't even ask how it got here. It was just under my covers. Scorpions native to the Las Vegas area. Anybody? I know they exist in Arizona.
I just assume if you have a desert, they're scorpions.
They're scorpions. Right. That's
okay.
My clue.
Germany.
Yeah. A report filed by the Venetian Resort Las Vegas, and I was telling Steve, I was like, for whatever reason, the last three times I've been to Vegas and stayed on the Strip and not in Fremont, for whatever reason, I've been in the Venetian. It's just, I don't know how
this
I
this is
to
not
it.
A sales pitch for
no,
me.
No, it's not.
Oh, I've stayed there. It's awesome.
Yeah. But the report said a man was bitten by a scorpion on his testicles around 8 a.m. The report said he told staff he was in a lot of pain, blamed the Venetian for the incident, was in the bed when he was sleeping, and this happened. He was diagnosed with a scorpion sting at an area hospital following the incident.
My first sting.
Everyone was in shock. No one believed me. Even I couldn't believe it. The incident number from the resort marked the event, adding that he was considering legal action. While they're confident the resort has policies and procedures in place to avoid situations like the one he found himself in, it's another thing the attorney said to ensure that the procedures are basically followed. For their part, officials from the Venetian Resort responded for comment saying, the resort has protocols for all incidents, and we can confirm they were followed in this incident. But they do say this, it's a good idea to always inspect your hotel room and surrounding areas upon checking in to the Venetian. In lovely Las Vegas.
Did that scorpion automatically become a bed bug? Well, I mean, technically it's a bug, and it's in your bed.
I also just wouldn't think to check into a hotel that nice and on the Strip and be like, let me check it for scorpions.
Yeah. Like, if I'm staying at the Motel 6, yeah. The Venetian, I'm not giving it a thought.
Well, did you see the picture of the scorpion actually hanging off of this guy's box?
No.
I did not.
It is, you look at it and you're like, man, this would really freak you out. How? Based on the fact that the whole thing is kind of orange in tint. So,
the scorpion
you know,
itself?
Normally, the pictures I've seen of scorpions don't look like that one. That looks like somebody took a, like a 3D printer.
Right, and just made one.
I want to make an orange scorpion.
Was it a big one or a small one?
It was probably 2 inches long, so not the biggest one in the world. But the fact
but
that
I've heard you'd rather get stung by the big ones. Apparently, this is my understanding. It might be wrong, but I guess the big ones typically use less venom than the tiny ones.
And the pinchers were still, or the stinger was still stuck in to the boxers.
God.
So even when he took his pants off, basically the scorpion was still clinging to the front of the boxers. I'm pretty sure he took that scorpion with him to the hospital. Just for identification.
Okay. All right. That makes sense.
What exactly is this? So our question, I once woke up and blank was going on. 206-803-ROCK.
It's one thing falling in love with a house, and quite another navigating the world of negotiating, mortgage lenders, and finding the budget that works best for you. Guidance from an agent who's a Realtor can make all the difference, because that's who we are. Realtors are members of the National Association of Realtors.
This episode is brought to you by Progressive Insurance. Whether you love true crime or comedy, celebrity interviews or news, you call the shots on what's in your podcast queue. And guess what? Now you can call them on your auto insurance, too, with the Name Your Price tool from Progressive. It works just the way it sounds. You tell Progressive how much you want to pay for car insurance, and they'll show you coverage options that fit your budget. Get your quote today at progressive.com to join the over 28 million drivers who trust Progressive. Progressive Casualty Insurance Company and Affiliates. Price and coverage match limited by state law.
1, 2, 3, 4. Those are numbers, but you already knew that. If you want to know what number you're going to pay each month for your car, use Kelley Blue Book My Wallet on Auto Trader. They're really good at numbers. Auto Trader.
This episode is brought to you by Allianz Travel Insurance. If you're the type of traveler who leaves everything to the last minute, then annual travel insurance was made for you. Buy your plan today, and you're covered for every trip you take in the next 365 days. Enjoy peace of mind knowing you're protected, whether you're heading out for a weekend getaway or an international vacation. Get the travel protection trusted by more than 70 million American travelers. Get a quote at AllianzTravelInsurance.com.
99.9 KISW. The shenanigans continue. This is the Men's Room with Miles and Thrill.
A question I once woke up and blank was going on. 206-803-ROCK.
Couple of quick texts here. It says, I woke up in college and my roommate, was nailing my girlfriend on his bed.
Oh no.
Someone else says, I woke up with my hair falling out. You see, my quote-unquote friends put Nair all over my head when I passed out first. I had a pretty,
what are you saying there?
Basically, he had to shave his head in the end, but he says, pretty devastating to a self-conscious high school freshman.
Jeez,
I bet it would be. And I woke up when lightning hit my childhood home. I thought the house had literally exploded and blew out a window in my parents' bedroom.
Damn,
that will wake you up.
I once woke up and a blank was going on. 206-803-ROCK.
Hello, Meg. Welcome to the men's room.
What up, my dudes?
Hola.
Hola. So, this actually wasn't me, but I was involved. My family had gone camping when I was about 2 as a toddler. And we got home. It was the next morning. And my mother woke up to me standing over her with a uncleaned, rusty fishing knife, having just stabbed her in the arm.
Jeez.
Yeah, she had to get a tetanus shot, for sure.
Yeah, if you get stabbed with a rusty blade, yes, best to get a tetanus shot. Why did this happen exactly?
Apparently, I used to be a psychopath. I don't know. She said when she woke up, I was kind of just sitting over her.
And you stabbed your mom with a rusty knife?
Yes.
Okay, so follow-up questions. You said you were a toddler, 2 years old, obviously a future serial killer. How many people have you killed so far into your adulthood?
I can't answer that on the grounds that I might incriminate myself.
Okay, that's a fair answer. Did you have any other weird episodes like that throughout childhood?
No, can't say that I did. My brother managed to do a lot of things to himself mostly, but I stayed pretty clean after that.
Okay. I stayed clean after stabbing my mom with a rusty knife.
I wouldn't know what the hell to do if my 2-year-old stabbed me with a knife when I was asleep. I'd wake up and go like, all right, devil kid.
Yeah, you're creepy, man.
I'm putting you out with the trash.
Just letting you know. Are you married?
Yes.
Have you shared the story with your husband?
Yes, I have. He's into it.
Do you have kids?
He's into getting stabbed?
Well, just, I'm dangerous.
Okay.
He likes that.
He's into that.
Are you redheaded?
I am.
Really? Wow.
Okay.
I had no idea. That's one out of left field.
However, did you guess?
I don't know. It was just a weird feeling I had.
You're redhead. I am.
Yeah.
We know. Uh-huh.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, he thinks I'm dangerous. I know exactly what the hell that means.
He's into it.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, that's a weird dynamic going on. I mean, good for them, though, man. If that's
I once woke up and blank was going on. 206-803-ROCK.
Hello, Rick. Welcome to the men's room.
Hey, guys. Hola.
Hola.
All right, so this probably happened maybe like 18 years ago, whatever, so it's been a while. So I was asleep with my wife, who I just was dating a few months, and I heard a noise, like my curtains moving or whatever. I look up, and there's a guy like halfway in my room, halfway out. So we made eye contact, and I had a few words for him, and then I basically... tried to chase him down, but he was pretty fast, so, yeah, that's
Well, did you? What I mean, the hell? You're not sleeping with your shoes on. This is you, right. You chase them out the door without.
It was when I was living in North Everett, and I was running down the street in just a pair of boxers at like 3 a.m.
Which in North Everett, no one's even going to bad an eye.
Exactly. I just fitting in with the crowd.
I like the fact that the guy was kind of fast. So did you get a good look at him at all? I mean, were you able to give a description?
I didn't call police. I didn't do anything. I just said, I was like, you're in the wrong house. Don't come back here, please. And then I chased after him. And then, my wife, anyways, she was mad because she said I left her there in my room, but.
What did she expect you to do?
I don't know. I'm not going back to sleep.
Do you want me to invite him in? I mean, like.
Well, sometimes no matter what you do is not the right thing. No matter what the situation
it
is.
I get it. I guess to a point she's small and, you know, she's not very confrontational or.
But you pointed out
that's why you handled it.
Right. The inherent danger was now no longer there because it was running down the street. So.
No, and I wasn't scared or anything. I was more surprised than anything.
So did you have the window open?
Yeah, I think it was open a little bit, and he crawled in through some alley, back alley or something, and, you know.
I mean, did this ever happen again? Did you ever see this guy again?
Oh, no. I mean, maybe. If I did, I wouldn't know. I wouldn't have known what he would look
all
like.
All right, who said the first thing? You made eye contact. Does he say, like, how's it going?
Right.
Like, what happens at this point?
Let me think on this. I think maybe I said something first, like, you're in the wrong house, MF-er. And he was, oh, I'm sorry. And I'm like,
Sorry. That's what he said.
Yeah, something like that. Like I said, it's been 18 years, so, you know.
Did he just politely take his legs out of the window and leave, or what?
Well, he was, you know how, like, when you say, if you're trying to jump up in the window and it's maybe 4 or 5 feet up, you got to jump up there and
pull yourself
up? Lift. So he was, like, up on that, you know, when he's up there, your arms are straight extended.
Yeah, like you did a big dip. You're
about ready to lift your leg kind of up, you know? So I caught him, like, mid that.
Okay. That's a weird one.
You seem very polite, though.
Right, exactly.
And please don't come back.
Nothing happened, and I didn't have firearms then, and I just chased him down the street, and he had crackhead speed or something.
Crackhead speed.
That's back when people still used that particular substance. I don't know about
these. Oh, the good old days, man.
Did it make you feel bad that, you know, like, he just outran you? No matter what.
Right, the crackhead.
Even, like, when you're in grade school, you have a race on the playground, and you get beat. It sucks.
No, I was pretty fast. I was pretty fast back then.
Not as fast as a crackhead.
I was going to say, you don't sound that fast.
But unless you're on a mat, man, the hardest thing you could ever do is fight in bare feet. You have no leverage.
Right.
I mean, unless you're a karate man, you know.
Yeah, some of those guys could be 120 pounds, but if they're on certain things, you really don't want to tangle with them.
No.
Regardless.
No, but not only that, you don't need to get stabbed.
You ever seen crackheads fight?
No.
Oh, man. He's not just back in the days of Baltimore, especially when crack was first exploding, and it seemed like everybody was doing it, but, you know, arguments still happen. And to this guy's point, I'm telling you, these two guys, as I remember, probably weighed about 120, like you said. And I mean, it was outside of a bar, so we all just walked outside, and it looked like they were in fast motion. I don't know if they were doing any damage.
That's why featherweight boxing is more fun than heavyweight.
Yeah, basically, it was like that.
You know,
but you get more punches, less power.
Like, these are not professional boxers, but they are professional crackheads. Look at them go.
I once woke up and a blank was going on. 206-803-ROCK.
I've seen heroin junkies try to fight.
Real, how slow and sloppy was that?
That's exactly what it is.
Really, just like, guys, don't even.
I'm gonna kick
the best
her
was
ass.
I was at an Apple Cup. These two guys obviously knew each other.
All right.
But they're older. Like, I would say probably in their 60s.
Okay.
They are hammered. They are about to fight. So, like, I just can't help myself. I kind of stop. Like, oh, no. And, like, their daughters, who are fully grown, like 40, are like, please don't do this. And, I mean, one guy throws a punch, they both fall.
Balance.
Yeah.
Hello, Colton. Welcome to the men's room.
Hola.
Hola.
So, I woke up one time. I had a cat, and she would normally, like, sleep in between my legs, and, like, that was totally normal, not thinking anything of it. So I woke up, it was like the middle of the night, and I realized that I still had a couple hours before I had to get up and go to bed, so I was trying to, like, reach down, scratch her head real quick.
Reach down between my legs, scratch the cat head. Yeah.
Yeah. And then as I'm laying there, I realized, like, this, she's making some weird noises right now. Like, what is going on? And I, like, sat up and turned on the light. And she had given birth to, like, 7 kittens in between my legs and my bed.
Oh, my God. Oh.
Was this an indoor-outdoor cat?
Yes.
Okay. And so I assume you knew she was pregnant, right?
Yeah. She was being really irritating before this, like, when she was trying to get herself pregnant. So we knew that this was coming. I just didn't expect it to happen.
Between your legs in the middle of the
so
night.
You could see the bulge. You could see the nipples. You knew that the kittens were on the
way. Is it, I mean, when a cat gives birth, I'm very happy to say I've never experienced that myself. I mean, is it just as sloppy as most other mammals?
She certainly was sloppy about it.
Well, the one thing about cats is they clean themselves quickly.
Right.
So the mom takes care of the kittens.
But she's not washing your sheets.
She cleaned herself and them. Right. She didn't clean my bed.
No, of course not.
which is the root of your problem.
More people would own cats if that happened.
Yeah.
So what do you do after the cat gives birth? How many kittens did she have?
I want to say like 6 or 7. She was a small cat, but it was like a really big litter.
But
for her
big vagina.
Yeah, that's what I'm saying.
Do you give them away? I mean, what do you do? Because now you're stuck with all these freaking kittens that you don't want. You call the neighbors, just hand them to kids on the street, what?
So we gave a couple away to some friends. I kept one.
What's the length of time that a cat needs to be with its mom before it can be, you know, rehomed?
A couple months, I think.
Okay. A couple of months, really?
Yeah, I know dogs typically
are.
We had to
keep them around for a while.
Dogs are what, 9 weeks?
8 or 9. VD just went through it. I think you said like 8 weeks or something. So a couple of
months. That's why I was curious with a cat, how long you got to keep them.
So, all right, now, let me ask you this, all right? So, okay, you don't want more cats, but now they've been bestowed upon you between your legs in the middle of the night. You have to keep them with their mom for a couple of months.
Yeah.
Was it hard to give the rest of them away? Because, look, I'm not going to lie to you. At that point, I'm like, all right, guys, you're cute. You can stay around.
Right.
Like, I don't want you here, but still, since you're here.
It kind of was. That's why I ended up keeping one. Because, they were, it's not their fault they were born in between my legs. They're like cute little kittens.
Well, you should get them little shirts
you
to say that.
You should have named one after you.
And then my last question for you, man. So what was your determining factor about the cat that you chose to keep? Was it behavior? Was it cute?
It was kind of a combination. He was like just a really chill cat, and he was super cute. He was a tuxedo cat.
I like those. Those typically are friendlier cats. I don't know what it is.
Well, they're dressed nicer.
They are.
You know, right. They have to have decorum if you're going to dress like that, obviously.
Well, I think...
that's why your hairless cat that you want, basically, is the crackhead we're talking.
I think the doctor...
I wearing fur, bitches!
What's a doctor... Dr. Gomez, what was he? What's an orange cat called? Is that a tabby?
That a tabby?
Calico? What is it? Tabby, I think it is. Orange tabby, maybe?
I just go with orange cat, to be honest with you.
But orange cat.
Yeah.
Thank you, Mike.
Tabbies are the brown ones that have the tiger stripes on them. Calico are the ones that have, like, the black, white, and orange spot.
Okay,
ones.
It wasn't that one.
Yeah, tuxedo cats are your black and white ones.
But they seem to be the friendlier ones. Or, like...
Which ones?
The black and white cats.
Tuxedo. No, they're tuxedo? Insane.
Really?
They're insane, yes.
I had one that was great.
Yeah, yours is a tuxedo, right?
No, mine are tabbies, and he's a jerk.
Well, because the cats that hang outside my place, like the all-black cat seems annoyed... If I have my thing open.
Yeah.
And then you're right. Your slider open, your door open?
Yeah. It's like he just wants to look in there, but he doesn't like me looking at him. And I just stare at him. And then the orange cat, if I open my slider and don't, like, I have to have the screen closed. Because he will just walk in.
Sure. And hang out. Yeah. Next thing you know, you got one on your couch, you know?
Right, but I mean, there's somebody's cat. I think they're my neighbor's cat that just, they just let him kind of free roam.
You don't ask the neighbor? For a little bit?
Not inside the home.
Ah, come on.
There's no guarantees you're going to leave.
Yeah.
You know,
if you knew the cat was a can of tuna, dude, don't do that. Can of tuna outside.
Get the cat outside.
Get the cat back out.
But then they're going to come by all the time. Look at this.
Like, hey, open your door.
They already come by too much for my taste.
You don't like cats?
But I thought you liked these cats initially, right?
I mean, I don't mind it. It's just that one. I mean, the black cat's kind of funny. Is like I said, he's just like, why are you looking at me? It's like, well, you're looking at my place. But the other one, he is super friendly. I mean, it's just amazing. And they'll just, like, no. Like, you're not coming in.
Do you go outside and pet him?
If I'm outside doing something, sure. I'll pet him. Okay. He's super friendly.
My friends have a cat.
But he's not allowed in the home.
I don't know how old their cat is, but it's old enough that it's in a diaper, which cracks me up.
Oh, no.
Yeah, the cat's in a diaper. And it's a very loud, chipper cat. Like, meow, meow.
Is it a girl?
Dude, I have no idea. I'd have to open the diaper.
It might not have to do with anything with age.
It is an old cat. I don't know.
Okay.
Honest to God, man. Oh.
Yeah. Ooh.
Yeah. So I haven't bothered to ask, but the cat likes to spend all its time in their bathroom. And they leave the faucet dripping just a little bit.
Yeah.
That's where the cat chooses to drink water. It's just the cat's deal. The problem is, I always forget they have a cat because the cat's always in the bathroom. So we were there a couple of weeks ago. I'm going to go to the bathroom. Basically, long story short, the cat meowed, scared the living bejesus out of me because I forgot it was there. But I was actively urinating in that moment. Oh, so no. Basically, yeah, I had to clean up like their wall and back. Because it made me jump, man. And so my stream came out of the toilet, like ricocheted around the house. I'm like, oh, my bad. My bad. Then my buddy's like, everything okay in there, man? I'm like, oh, don't worry about it. It's all good.
I once woke up and a blank was going on. 206-803-ROCK.
I peed on your stuff.
Is that my fault?
I forgot the cat was there. Hello, Daniel. Welcome to the men's room.
Hola, Michola.
Hola.
So, my story is one time, I lived in Wyoming at the time, and I was... Are you there?
Yeah, man.
Oh, okay. I couldn't hear.
Well, no one was saying anything, so technically there was nothing to hear, but we are here.
Right, we're listening to you. It's not Wyoming. Right, there's people here.
So I was living in Wyoming, and on my birthday, I went out and just got hammered. I didn't have a car, so I made sure I locked up the house before I left, and I knew it was going to be... I get back from being all... Well, I'm all wasted, and I get back about 3 o'clock in the morning, and I realized I'd left my keys in the house when I locked the house.
This is a problem.
So I stacked up some stuff that was outside to the window from my roommate's window because I couldn't get into mine because it was too high up. But my roommate's window, there was stuff right here, and I could get right in through their window, and I'd go in. And I figured I'll go in, I'll open the door, put the stuff back, and then everything would be fine. Well, no, I got in through the window, and as soon as I got through that window, I passed out right on my roommate's bed. I woke up the next morning to... I heard some rustling up above me in the window, and I looked up there, and there was a cop. He's like, "Don't move!" And I was like, "What?" So then I'm like, "Okay, what am I doing here?" Then there was another one pounding on my bedroom door, and I'm like, "I got to get up to get that." And they're like, "Don't move!" And I'm like, "Well, how am I supposed to answer the door?" "It's just another one of us. So should I let him in?" "Yes, I have to move to do that."
This seems like a very long conversation to have. Like,
can we get up and answer the door or not, dude?
He's out there yelling to get in.
I'm frozen laying in bed, and they're trying to tell me, answer the door, and then another one's saying, don't move. And I'm just like, I finally get up. About 12 cops come into my place. They're already in my place, I guess. And I just let three through the door in the bedroom, and one was out the window. And I'm like, what is going on? And they cuff me, and they bring me out in the living room, and my landlord's out there, and they go, "He says he lives here." And the landlord looks at me and says, "Nope, he don't live here." Because I had my hair all the way down. Now, I have my hair shaved on the sides and back, and it's really long on top, but I have it in the back in a ponytail, so people don't really realize I have long hair.
So he didn't vouch for you?
So he didn't vouch for me, and I'm like, wait. I said, "Move my hair away from my face." And they finally did, and he looked at my face and was like, "Oh, it is him." And the second they realized it was me, I tell you, it was no more than 15 seconds, and all 7 cop cars and 15 cops were gone.
Yeah, they don't need to be there anymore, man. So.
I can't believe they have that many cops in Wyoming. That's more than Seattle.
Yeah, I know. I couldn't either.
That's crazy.
But I was also, probably being under investigation at the time.
I cannot imagine that.
Really? Had a little eye on you, huh?
There's nothing about you that would tell me the cops might be watching you.
I once woke up and blank was going on. 206-803-ROCK.
My 13-year-old acts like a puppy again. Almost overnight, she's a different dog.
Perfect poops.
When people switch their dog's food to the farmer's dog, the effects can seem like magic. But there's no magic involved. It's simply real meat and vegetables with all the nutrients dogs need instead of highly processed pellets. No tricks, just smarter, healthier pet food delivered in packs portioned for your dog. It's amazing what real food can do. Get 50% off your first order at thefarmersdog.com/nomagic.
Listening to your favorite podcast? That's smart. Earning your degree online from Southern New Hampshire University? That's really smart. With 24/7 access to coursework, no set class times, and dedicated student support, you can go to school when and where it works for you. Low online tuition means you can even do it for less. And dedicated student support means we'll be with you from day one to graduation and beyond. Join a community of learners just like you. Go to snhu.edu today to start your free application.
From executive producer Jimmy Kimmel.
What's up, team? Just two people can't launch a brand. It takes a village.
We are MMD Hollywood.
Wowee.
Which stands for medical marijuana.
Due to restrictions, we can't tell you everything about our new reality series. But what we can say is the idea behind it is fully baked.
I don't know.
High Hopes. Streaming 420 on Hulu.
This is a promotional message for Alexia Sweet Potato Fries. And in the process of elucidating you on all the wondrous virtues Alexia Sweet Potato Fries have to offer, I intend to do so in a prodigious manner befitting of such a superlative side. That's because all Alexia creations are creatively crafted, from sweet potato fries that accomplish a delicate balance of sweet and savory without GMOs or superfluous additives, to the eloquent lexicon of our advertisements, like this one. Because every Alexia experience is intended to feel creatively crafted and exceptional without exception. Alexia Sweet Potato Fries. Do procure them in your grocer's freezer.
My 13-year-old acts like a puppy again. Almost overnight, she's a different dog.
Perfect poops.
When people switch their dog's food to the farmer's dog, the effects can seem like magic. But there's no magic involved. It's simply real meat and vegetables with all the nutrients dogs need instead of highly processed pellets. No tricks, just smarter, healthier pet food delivered in packs portioned for your dog. It's amazing what real food can do. Get 50% off your first order at thefarmersdog.com/nomagic.
From executive producer Jimmy Kimmel.
What's up, team? Just two people can't launch a brand. It takes a village.
We are MMD Hollywood.
Wowee.
Which stands for medical marijuana.
Due to restrictions, we can't tell you everything about our new reality series. But what we can say is the idea behind it is fully baked.
I don't know.
High Hopes. Streaming 420 on Hulu.
Listening to your favorite podcast? That's smart. Earning your degree online from Southern New Hampshire University? That's really smart. With 24/7 access to coursework, no set class times, and dedicated student support, you can go to school when and where it works for you. Low online tuition means you can even do it for less. And dedicated student support means we'll be with you from day one to graduation and beyond. Join a community of learners just like you. Go to snhu.edu today to start your free application.
What's up? It's your boy, The Ted Smith from The Men's Room. And did you know I have a podcast? Well, I do. The Podcast. New episodes uploaded every Wednesday on the Odyssey app.
99.9 KISW. We return to The Men's Room with Miles and Thrill.
Police are searching for a suspect who allegedly sexually abused a man who was sleeping on a subway in Manhattan, according to the New York Police Department. Victim is 25 years old. He fell asleep on the northbound number 6 train as it entered the Astor Play Station about 2 o'clock in the morning. Police say the man then woke up to the suspect's hands down his pants. The victim not physically injured. The NYPD, they released a photo of the suspect. They describe him as a man with a heavy build. He was last seen wearing a dark-colored baseball cap, green shirt, tan pants, and tan boots. Police want to know if you recognize the suspect. I once woke up and blank was going on. 206-803-ROCK.
Hello, Josh. Welcome to the men's room.
Hey, hola, homies.
Hola.
Yeah, so a crew of us used to get together and take our rock crawlers out to do the Rubicon Trail, which is a rock crawling trail out there in the Tahoe area up in, like, Cali, Nevada area.
All right.
And, we go out, we'd be partying and drinking while we were camping and stuff. It was a good time. But one night I was sleeping in my tent, and the ground's pretty porous in the area where we were camping, and so you could kind of feel people walking around or things moving around. And there was something heavy out there, like pretty much making my sleeping bag bounce around, walking around. And at the same time, I kind of had to use the bathroom. I had been fighting off the thoughts of having to do a number 2 out in the bushes, and I'm sitting there going, man, I don't know what's out there right now, but it's big. And now next thing I know, I can hear this breathing. It's this big, heavy, like massive breathing. And I'm just like, dude, this is a bear. And anyway, so I'd carry a shotgun with me when you're out there because it's desolate wilderness. I mean, it's just you and whatever you brought. And so I racked the shotgun, and the thing didn't, I mean, it didn't take off or anything. It's just sitting there right outside my tent. And I'm thinking to myself, man, I'm feeling like I got to go to the bathroom. I got a bear outside my tent. I don't know what the hell to do. And I just sat there and just thought, well, I mean, if I got to, you know, fire some rounds off, I'm going to have to, I'm not going to let the thing kill me and eat me or whatever's going to happen. And after about a, you know, minute or two, which seemed like 3 days, especially when you're trying not to go to the bathroom, which is kind of counterintuitive when you got something that big outside your tent. Yeah, it was, anyway, I ended up leaving, thankfully. But next morning, you know, went out and, well, later on, I ended up having to go to the bathroom. But, you know, I wake up in the morning and I'm like, all right, well, you know, what the heck? I go around the back of my tent and I'm relieving myself, taking my morning, you know, number one. And all of a sudden there's, look down and the freaking paw prints are like right outside my tent. The thing walked right up to my tent and I just, that was about one of the scariest things I've ever experienced in my life.
How long was the bear there? With you sitting there with the shotgun in your hand, pinching one off, and you know there's the bear. How long did it stay?
Oh, like 5 hours. No, it had to be just a couple of minutes, but it seemed like it was way too long. And the amount of concentration it takes to, you know, because when you're drinking too, and you've, you know, really tied one on, drinking a bunch of whiskey and stuff, you know, it's when the nature calls, you know, you got that happening, and the bear's there, and
which I would think would make me almost just do it based on that.
How many more nights did you have to sleep there?
We were there for like two more nights before we carried on to the next camp.
I was going to see. I would carry on to the next camp now.
Did you have a hard time? Did you have a hard time sleeping the next couple of nights?
Oh yeah, for sure. No, it was. I've never cuddled with a shotgun before, but I did every night that night after.
Yeah, I would too, brother. There's no doubt about it. Good Lord.
Yep.
Good times.
Yep.
I just like the underlying thing about that whole story is like, and I got to poop. Like, I really got to poop.
You need to leave.
Yeah.
Bear, I just need you to go away. I don't want to get mauled while I'm pooping, brother.
It's kind of like when you have that pain in a hotel room you're sharing with somebody, and they're in there taking a shower. You're like, please.
I know. That's why when I stayed with that guy, Jerry, I just went down to the lobby, did my business. And again, because he's taking a shower, and I understand he played college football. He's got all that going on. So when I came back in, he's giving me a confused look. I thought you were sleeping, man. I said, dude, I woke up, and same thing. We've been drinking. I had to go, so I went down to the lobby. Hey, why didn't you just come into this bathroom? I said, because you're in there showering. I had to poop, dude. He's like, no, seriously, you're coming to do that. I said, Jerry, listen, man, if I got to poop and you're in the shower, I will go down to the lobby. Then there's this awkward pause, and he's just looking at me and goes, you're a weird dude. Okay.
Yeah, like we always say, sometimes if I'm staying in a hotel room with somebody, like after breakfast, like I might just stay in the lobby and take care of business so I don't blow up the whole room.
Absolutely, man.
Yeah. I once woke up and a blank was going on. 206-803-ROCK.
Hello, Jessica. Welcome to the men's room.
Hola.
Hola.
So this just happened back in 1st December The weekend before, however, we decided to go and stay at a hotel room just here in town. And, of course, just the two of us. We got absolutely hammered that night. Go to bed, pass out in the bed, and then somehow, all of a sudden, I wake up and I hear pounding on the hotel door. And I hear, Jessica, Jessica. So I get up and I go open the front door, like, what the heck's going on? And my soon-to-be new husband is standing outside in the hallway completely naked.
what was he doing out there?
So he said that he got up in the middle of the night drunk to go to the bathroom, but he went through the wrong door.
Oh, so he walked down the hallway instead of the bathroom.
We have a buddy that did it in Germany. I did it in Mexico. Yep. I mean, it's hard to explain, right? But the same condition. You were absolutely hammered. The goal is just to go to the bathroom, and you realize I am locked out of my hotel room.
Yep, no key, no phone, no clothes, nothing. And I don't know, I was so drunk. I don't know how I managed to wake up. Because normally, you know, when you pass out like that, you're out all night.
You're out, yeah. Did he have a backup plan? Like, knowing that you're absolutely hammered, and you're right, people sleep deeper. Did he have a backup plan? Like, all right, if she doesn't answer the door in like an hour, I'm going to snatch a towel from housekeeping or something.
Yeah, so he said that he went into the stairwell to try to, like, hide in there, because the stairwell door was right by the end where our room was at. And he said that he got cold, so he opened the door again. And then he thought, like, oh, all he said was, like, oh, my gosh, like, here it is. I'm going to have to make that decision to walk down to the hotel lobby naked, apologize to everybody, and try to get a key.
Was this a nice hotel?
Well, so we live in Paulsville, and I think we were in Silverdale. So as nice as Silverdale hotels are.
Is it a more modern hotel?
No, it's just one on the beach downtown.
Okay, you might be lucky. There might not be cameras in the hallway.
Yeah.
If not, someone's watching this on loop, having a real good time at your husband's expense.
Yeah, I was caught on video peeing on a tree outside, and then locked out of the room, which turns out I wasn't even locked out of. And no one said anything, but God knows, that next morning when we went down to the lobby, just every employee there, when they saw me, the smile said it all. Like, security has shown,
yes.
Okay, it's fine. It's fine.
Look at this guy.
I once woke up and blank was going on. 206-803-ROCK.
Hello, Brian. Welcome to the men's room.
How's it going, fellas?
Hola.
So, kind of a little bit of a last story along those lines. Back in the mid-90s, I was in the Air Force stationed in Korea. And we went to one of the air bases, Osan Air Base, which is near Seoul. Right outside that base is a big bar district. So we were out there, me and about five buddies. And we went out to the bars and proceeded to get really hammered. When we got back, we just had gotten one hotel room for all six of us. So I think everybody, you know, a couple guys doubled up in the bed. Somebody slept in a chair. And I just grabbed a couple blankets and I fell asleep on the floor.
It's the beauty of being drunk.
Yeah. But that was all right, you know. I'm sleeping on the floor, and I get woken up by one of my buddies getting out of the bed, and you can just tell he was still really hammered. So he walks around the room holding his pillow. He throws the pillow down on the floor near me, walks across the room, stops, and decides to urinate on a coat rack. He thinks he's in the bathroom.
Okay.
One of those pole coat racks that's about 5-6 feet tall, and he just standing there urinating on it. So I said, what are you doing? And he says, I have to go to the bathroom. I'm in the bathroom. I said, no, you're not. You're in the room with us. And he just said, oh, and he finished, and he went back to bed like nothing happened.
I've done it. Brother,
so
I've done
we've
it.
All been there.
I quickly jumped up because I had been sleeping on the floor, and he had just urinated on the floor. So I quickly found a chair and tried to sleep sitting up for the rest of the night.
I think you made the right decision. Look, we've all done it. I peed it. When we first moved to Seattle, I thought we had a leak somewhere in our apartment because every time I went to my laundry basket, the laundry was damp. And I could not figure it out. It was three nights in a row. Finally, on night four, I realized I kept walking into the closet. Basically, I woke up to myself peeing in the laundry basket. And I said, okay, it's not a leak. But the worst I had, we're living in Belltown at this time. My wife had moved out here. I just want to poop. That's all I want to do. And now she's screaming at me, like, what are you doing? I'm like, I'm taking an S. She said, you're sitting in the chair in the bedroom. I was like, good looking out, babe. Let me just get up.
And, I once woke up and blank was going on. 206-803-ROCK.
Yeah, that seems worse.
I've done the urinating. I've never done the number two.
That's the only time that I've peed on an ex-girlfriend. And same thing. She, what are you doing? She's still in bed. I'd gotten out of bed, just turned around, and peed back on her. I peed in my laundry basket. I peed in the plant in Mexico. This is the only time where I'm trying to actively poop. And I'm glad, real glad, she called me before anything touched cotton.
I once woke up and a blank was going on. 206-803-ROCK.
Hello, Aaron. Welcome to the men's room.
Hola, gentlemen.
Hola.
So I'll tell you the end of it, which was me waking up, and let me know if you'd like to hear how I got there. The short version is I woke up in Texas, in an extremely hot apartment with no electricity, and the door was open to somebody's bedroom. This was in an apartment, and I didn't have any idea where I was at. I was highly drunk, and I could clearly see, unfortunately, my friend and some lady he had met having relations. How about that? And they were both completely nude.
Yeah, I hope so, if they're having relations.
Yeah.
I want to see it all. Yeah.
Yeah, I guess that makes it harder.
Right.
But the whole, so this was in college, and me and a friend of mine had decided there was literally a place, this was in East Texas, called the Chicken Ranch, just like Best Little Whorehouse in Texas.
Okay.
And the girls actually lived in, it was a giant house that had a stage, and they would come down the stairs early in the day for brunch, or for lunch. So we had decided we were going to go there for lunch because it was BYOB in Texas. I don't know if that's true here or not. If there's nothing on, if they don't wear anything, then it's BYOB, which I always thought was crazy. So we went there though because we heard that they had good hamburgers and steaks. So we brought a little beer and we were having some beers and we run out. And my friend's like, well, I have some at the dorm. I'll go back and get it. I said, great. So I'm sitting there by myself at the front of the stage eating a hamburger while there's like a girl in front of me with nothing on dancing in front of me, which was kind of odd. But anyways, I'll jump ahead. So he gets back. We wind up staying there much later at a girl's. It's like, let's say we got there about noon and now it's probably like 4 or 5 and the girls come out and say, hey, will you go buy us some drinks? Here's some money. You can keep the change. Here's what we want. We want this. We want this. So we got a whole list of stuff for the girls and we brought it back and we literally probably had like $200 left over. And so, that's what we used to tip them for the rest of the evening. And, why not? So I guess they thought we had some money and we were pretty much high rollers, but we proceeded to get completely hammered. We closed that bar down. And then that's why I woke up in a stripper's house who clearly hadn't paid any of her electric bills or anything like that.
Oh, oh man.
To the sight I saw.
Okay.
All right, let me ask you this. Would you do it again?
Probably not. Well, for a couple of reasons. I'm married.
Well, I'm talking age-wise, you know, if you're the same age, the same situation.
Yeah. Maybe. I just know the hangover would hurt a lot more now.
Yeah, that's for sure.
But back then, yeah. It was fun, and it was just, I just thought it was kind of funny. I mean, but where else? I mean, it was our money now anyways. I just felt kind of bad and also thought it was kind of funny that we just basically gave them their money back.
You know what?
Like, maybe that's why they said keep the change, because they thought, look,
if we play the odds here, and we know we're, like, at least we get our money back, right?
Yeah. Right.
Well, I've been to a BYOB strip club before. It is.
So have I. It's awesome.
It is awesome.
Yeah.
It is, man.
But I agree with him where it's crazy just in the sense of, like, look, if I went to the place and you served alcohol, you might cut me off at some point, right, depending.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
But you roll in there and you hand them, like, 2 6-packs and a handle of Jack, and they're like, cool.
Oh,
and every time, if you drink that whole handle, they're like, all right.
First of all, when you go to these places, if you go to a strip club, you sit there with your friends or you get up on the rail or wherever you want to be for your thing or whatever you're going to do, you're going to do. But this was in Cherry Hill, New Jersey. And so, yes, we came in with one big handle bottle.
Yep.
We came in with either a case or 12-pack of beer. But everybody's bringing in their stuff. And, like, in New Jersey, which is, hey, you know, everybody is very upfront and everybody's coming up and talking. Hey, you got Jack Daniels? We got Grey Goose.
Right.
You want some Grey Goose? You give you some Jack Daniels. And the next thing you know, like, you're tossing, you know, Milwaukee Best across the room and they're throwing back stuff to you. And, like, now you kind of know everybody that's kind of around you.
Yeah, the camaraderie.
All
yeah.
doing shots together. And it just turns into, like, I mean, it's not that you're not checking out the girls, but it's more like just a bunch of dudes bro down.
It's like a party with naked chicks.
Well, New Jersey's weird, too, because if you go to a strip club that serves alcohol, by, like, the third girl, finally we sit to the bartender and we're like, what is going on? Like, everybody's in bathing suits. She's like, serve
we
alcohol.
Have a liquor license.
So they can't take their tops off. And I was like, all right.
Yeah.
Like, what are we doing here then? We're going to just sat on the beach and drink beer.
I know, at that point.
Right? Well, they're strip club. Oh. They're not stripping.
I'll tell you something else. The liquor license in New Jersey are so hard to get. There's a definitive number of them.
And they won't go above that number.
Typically, they are assigned to the building. So the building or the address, they have the liquor license. They pay millions of dollars for these things. And if you have one, you pass it on. It's part of the sale of the place. Like people look to
actively. Yeah, so the sale of the place sounds like it's extreme. It's not for the place. It's for the license.
But on the flip side, if you go to a restaurant, now a restaurant might not be able to get a liquor license. They've been on the list for 10 years to try to get a liquor license in their place, or a really good Italian restaurant. It's BYOB. So when you go there, they have a cork fee.
If you want to
bring a couple bottles, whatever the cork fee is for the bottle is the bottle. But if you bring in beer or if you bring in hard liquor, you're unscrewing it. And so
do you just keep it at your table?
They bring a little cooler over. They have the thing that stands up for the wine where you put it in ice if it's white or
I don't know what that's called, but yeah, the silver thing.
They give you like a little igloo cooler for the rest of your beer. And all those things.
I would lose my mind in New Jersey.
You get whatever you want to eat because when you're not paying for the liquor bill, you know, $45 steak is a $45 steak, but I will drink more than $45 worth, especially in a nice place that has, you know,
the markups and all that.
Yeah, different stuff to drink. And I had never in a ton of food, like especially at this Italian place.
Yeah.
So much pasta, you cannot believe it. And you're just sitting there like cracking your own beers. And then when the waiter or waitress comes around, they'll be like, hey, do you want another beer? And you're like, yeah, they'll reach in the quarter, pop it, you know, pour it for you. You're like, this is too much. This is.
I mean, awesome. That's how the BYOB places in Maryland were, the strip clubs.
Yeah.
Like, we would just give the girl that was bartending, like, the 30 rack. She keeps it back there in the cooler, and then you just tip her a dollar or two every time you get some of your beers.
Oh, yeah. Mm-hmm. I did like that. But like I said, I'm going to get much more rip-roaring drunk.
I once woke up, Ben Blank was going on, 206-803-ROCK.
My 13-year-old acts like a puppy again. Almost overnight, she's a different dog.
Perfect poops.
When people switch their dog's food to the farmer's dog, the effects can seem like magic. But there's no magic involved. It's simply real meat and vegetables with all the nutrients dogs need instead of highly processed pellets. No tricks, just smarter, healthier pet food delivered in packs portioned for your dog. It's amazing what real food can do. Get 50% off your first order at thefarmersdog.com/nomagic.
Listening to your favorite podcast? That's smart. Earning your degree online from Southern New Hampshire University? That's really smart. With 24/7 access to coursework, no set class times, and dedicated student support, you can go to school when and where it works for you. Low online tuition means you can even do it for less. And dedicated student support means we'll be with you from day one to graduation and beyond. Join a community of learners just like you. Go to snhu.edu today to start your free application.
From executive producer Jimmy Kimmel.
What's up, team? Just two people can't launch a brand. It takes a village.
We are MMD Hollywood.
Wowee.
Which stands for medical marijuana.
Due to restrictions, we can't tell you everything about our new reality series. But what we can say is the idea behind it is fully baked. High Hopes. Streaming 4/20 on Hulu.
Recess recreated the cocktails you know and love, like a lime margarita and a grapefruit Paloma, but without the alcohol. So you can enjoy the flavors and feelings of your favorite drinks without the hangover. Each lightly sparkling canned mocktail is infused with functional ingredients and made with real fruit, all with only 25 calories or less. So whether you're relaxing after work or hanging out with friends, Recess Zero Proof Craft Mocktails are a guilt-free way to unwind. Head to takearecess.com/mocktails now to get 15% off the Recess Mocktail Sampler Pack.
99.9 KISW. The Men's Room returns with Miles and Thrill.
Tara Daly from the Daily Mix Morning Show on the way. We will sit and spin today the worst with the 10 worst lyrics in classic rock.
All right.
That's coming up right after emails on our question. I once woke up and blank was going on. 206-803-ROCK.
Hello, Dave. Welcome to the Men's Room.
Taco Tuesday.
Hola.
Is that a thing, Taco Tuesday?
I believe so. Yes, I've heard of that before.
Okay, so I have another camping story for you guys.
All right.
When I was a kid, 7 or 8 years old probably, my dad was an archaeologist for the state of Utah. And so I spent a lot of time down in southern Utah. While he categorized rock art sites, I would walk around, look for arrowheads and pottery and just catch lizards and stuff. But
one of the fun things we did was when he got off work, we drove down. It was always dark when we got there. So we'd set up our tent, and in the morning, it was kind of fun to wake up and see where we were, you know, the canyons or whatever. But this one morning, I woke up by, I swear it was something stepping on my head. We heard a lot of noise outside the tent, and I said, Mom, something just stepped on my head. I think it was a cow or something. And so we looked outside, and my dad had unknowingly set up our tent right next to a salt lick. And there was a herd of maybe, I don't know, 25 or 30 cows that surrounded our campsite.
You got stepped on by a cow on your head.
I didn't actually get stepped on by a cow. I'm sure it was licking the dew off the tent or something. But for me, I thought I got stepped on by a cow. I was only 8. I didn't know.
No, instead, it was trying to lick you through a tent, which is rather erotic. What are some of the cool things you got to see as a result of your dad being an archaeologist?
No, it was so much fun. I had a great childhood. My dad had a 1970 CJ5, and we got to see the most awesome scenery because he had special permission from the Navajo tribe to go down these roads that nobody got to go down. So we got to see these Indian ruins and stuff that people just didn't get to see.
Any dinosaur bones? Because Utah's kind of known for that.
Yep.
No, we saw there's dinosaur tracks down there. We never saw dinosaur bones.
Cool enough for me.
Yeah, that works.
Yeah, no, it was cool. It's good childhood.
And what do you do for a living now?
I'm actually a general contractor. I build homes for the Muckleshoot Indian tribe.
All right.
Nice.
Staying with the tribal theme. I like that.
Very cool.
It came back around.
Did they finish the hotel?
Yes, they did. It's open. Go stay there. It's pretty awesome.
Hallelujah.
I know.
Oh, my God. This is going to make White River Amphitheater a lot more easy for me.
For everyone.
Yes, exactly.
That place is going to get booked out, man.
Man, that tower is freaking huge.
Oh, yeah.
It is massive.
It looks Vegas-y. You know, like, walk up on it, especially when you're walking in the main entrance, you look over there, you're like, Jesus, man.
I know, but it gets you excited to go back to the casino.
Yeah, it does. I once woke up and blank was going on. 206-803-ROCK.
Hello, John. Welcome to the men's room.
Hola, fellas. How are we today?
Hola. Doing well.
I haven't told this story and discussed it in quite a long time, and the only reason that it came up recently was one of my son's buddies was back from school, and he was regaling us with some stories of this, that, and the other thing. And my son later asked me, he goes, "Did you guys ever used to do any crazy stuff like that when you were in college?" And I was in college in the mid 80s, and I said, yeah, you know, I did. So I told him, I went to a school in upstate New York. I was on a ice hockey scholarship, and some of the guys on my team were, they were the guys that were, you know, lack of a magnet with regards to moral compass kind of guys.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, it's hockey.
And guy on our team, one of the guys on our team who sat next to me happened to be in one of our regular towny bars. We were in a small town. And he was working, and he was a bit of a player. So he was working the barmaid, and she happened to live upstairs. And he ended up taking her home after they closed down. And the next day at hockey practice, I'm getting dressed, and he's late. He's not there. Pretty soon he shows up, and he sits down next to me, and he's got this look on his face like something major happened. I'm looking at him like, God, Dick, what's the matter? What happened? He goes, you're never going to believe this. He goes, I was just at Tracy's place, and he goes, I went to wake up. You know, I was with her last night, and I said, yeah, I remember. He goes, she dropped a deuce. She took an S on my chest.
And I'm
like, what?
While he was sleeping?
And he woke up. He woke up like this. So, of course, we're like, you got to be kidding me. So we're on the ice at practice. Pretty soon, one of the other guys goes, do you hear what happened to him last night? So we all kind of gather around in the corner, and he said, he was home with her. They did the nasty, and then he passed out because he was hammered. She woke up in the middle of the night to him opening up. Remember this rack stereo systems, right, with a turntable on top? He flipped it up, and he pissed all over her stereo.
Oh, so this was retribution.
She threw a shoe at him like, are you kidding me? And he laid back down laughing, and he passed out. And then when he got up, she had squatted, dropped the deuce on him. So he made the mistake of telling me this. He was an upperclassman, and I was a freshman. So I tell a couple of guys, we hear exactly what happened. And so one of our other upperclassmen dispatched our student trainer,
and he went over to the food services place where we all ate and came back, and on a paper towel, he had a big chunk of peanut butter, and we sat it right in his stall, so when he got off the ice, it was sitting there waiting for him.
That
was one of the grossest things.
What did your son think of the story?
My son looked at me horrified. he was horrified. He looked at me and he goes, "You're kidding, right?" And I said, "No, that really happened." And then about 10 seconds later, he goes, "That's awesome." Yeah, but I did get the weird look from my wife, like, "You're kidding, right?"
Oh, you had never told her that one?
Yeah, no.
Yeah, that's a weird
one. No, that's been in the vault for quite a while.
Do you follow him on Facebook?
Yeah, no.
Okay.
I don't do Facebook.
I'm just curious how these people have progressed in
life. Yeah, what are you doing now? Because last time I saw you.
I once woke up and blank was going on. 206-803-ROCK.
She really liked her turntable.
The stereo was a big deal in the mid-80s.
It was. It wasn't cheap. Deal.
It was a huge investment. It was much more expensive than a television, which was expensive then at the time. Mm-hmm. And if you had a really nice rack system, you had huge speakers, you had an equalizer tape deck, you had a turntable
and
tuner.
And if you pee on it, you get pooped on.
Yeah.
Hello, Kate. Welcome to the men's room.
Hola, guys.
Hola.
So this was a while back, but I was living with someone that tended to throw a lot of parties. She involved herself with knowing a lot of people in the military. At the time, I had a job that I worked at like 6 in the morning, so I never took part of these parties. Well, one night, I wake up at like 2 in the morning. There's a stranger in my bed.
Mm.
Like, I have no idea who this guy is. He's like trying to kiss me or something. I don't know.
What?
Nothing weird, naked undercovers, nothing like that. But it was like, I had no idea who this guy was. Seriously cringe. Like, I still gag when I talk about it to this day. So I wake up. I'm like screaming, yelling, slamming doors. Get out of my room. Get out of my room. Well, she had the music playing so loud that she didn't hear any of this commotion. And the reason I think he got in my room is because my bedroom had an adjacent door to, like, the main bathroom.
Oh,
you walk in.
Okay.
So what I think happened is he went to use the bathroom, came in through the other door that came into my room, and saw me there, right? So that is so gave me, like, the heebie-jeebies. I'm like, oh, my goodness. This guy woke up. I'm like, I don't even know who this person is. So the next morning, I'm like, yo, roommate, hey, you need to stop, like, you know, maybe having some random guys over here or whatever. And she had the audacity to get mad at me because I didn't make a big enough scene for her to hear me at the time that it happened. And then she was like, well, we could have kicked his butt and da-da-da-da-da. She had no idea who the guy was.
So, did he just leave on his own, or what happened is you're making the commotion? Even though she didn't hear it, what is the guy doing?
He just walked out of my bedroom. I'm assuming he went back to wherever the party was in the house. And no one ever heard or seen from him again.
That's wild.
That is a weird one.
Well, I'm glad you made it out of there okay. Anyway.
Yeah, so thank God I was perfectly fine ever since I locked my doors. I'll tell you that much.
Yeah,
I bet you did.
Yeah. Let's just say me and that person are not friends anymore because I just was like, I'm not putting myself in this. But yeah, one of the scariest things I've ever woken up to, for sure.
I'm sorry that happened to you, but I'll be dead honest with you. I was desperately hoping that when we went to your call, you said, yeah, I used to work at this bar, and this guy peed on my turntable, and I got him back while he was sleeping.
I once woke up, and a blank was going on. 206-803-ROCK.
Hello, Joe. Welcome to the men's room.
Hola.
Hola.
All right. So, go to my kid's field day and meet this really hot chick at field day. And turns out she's at my kid's school.
I got a bath while he was asleep.
Wait, say it again. What'd you say?
So I met a chick at field day. Turns out she's a teacher at my kid's school.
Okay.
Yeah, super hot, banging body. She's a runner, you know, that whole thing. Anyway, so we start fooling around for a few months. And I'm over there one night. I go to work early in the morning, so I was waking up at like 4 in the morning. And in the middle of the night, I get woken up by this guy flipping the light on, saying, hey, you're in the bed with my chick, and
uh-oh,
he's swinging at me. Turns out that she's still seeing this guy on the side. She was seeing both of us.
So did that put an end to your relationship?
Oh, yeah. Well, we didn't have much of a relationship other than the bedroom, but yeah, so I called the cops on this guy.
All right.
Yeah, and because, you know, I'm thinking, hey, he just broke in and, you know, trying to assault me and stuff, and I end up calling the cops. Well, the cop ends up pulling me off to the side. He was like, hey, man, get away from this chick. She's crazy.
The cop told you that?
The yeah, the cop told me that.
Huh.
The cop's like, hey, this chick seeing him too, she let him in the house knowing you were in there, you know, in the bed. Well, you know, because I think that he broke in. Well, no, she let him in.
Yeah, time to leave.
Yeah, I think the cop's right at that point.
Did this guy get any good shots in on you, or are you able to hold him off?
He's gone.
Oh, okay.
I like that the cop's like, look, man, if the guy broke in, I understand. Mm-hmm. She let him in. Do not deal with her anymore.
No. Well, and it's not good if the cops already know her.
That's a definite one. Oh, did Kelly here? Uh-huh. She's crazy, dude.
That whole force has been here.
Well, thank God she's taking care of your kids. I once woke up and blank was going on. 206-803-ROCK.
Hello, Mike. Welcome to the men's room.
Hola.
Hola.
Yeah, my story is I had a weasel intruder in my bedroom.
Where did you live that you were around weasels?
Monroe.
Okay.
Home of the weasel.
Those Monrovian weasels.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. Okay. Are they friendly animals? I don't know a lot about weasels. Are they aggressive?
I didn't either. I didn't know a thing about a weasel. So anyway, I'm sleeping. We're sleeping good at night, you know, and all of a sudden I hear this something going on next to me. And I turn on the light next to me, and here's these claws. I mean, a weasel claw is like webbed, and they're just scary.
Did you learn of this in that moment?
He looks incredibly cute, the weasel.
Sure.
Well, not at that time.
Hang on. We'll get back to
it. Once again, bedroom colors, here are the seven words you can't say on the radio. Sucker, mother, and please keep those words in mind when calling. Now back to the program.
All right, Mike, so you said, oh, shoot.
Yeah. And my wife would have been totally freaked out. I mean, she would have made me sell this place, probably.
Okay.
And I was being as quiet as I could, you know, and I grabbed a blanket and I chased after this weasel, and I caught him at the end of the hallway, and ended up grabbing him from the back of the, you know, the neck area.
Right.
So I threw him up outside in the backyard, and I washed my hands. You know, they smell like you know, like goat.
Okay.
You know, if you ever touch a goat or whatever. And
it's a wild animal.
Yeah, yeah. So I went to bed, and I went, how did that thing get in here? You know? And so I went downstairs in the kitchen, and there he is again.
The same weasel.
Same weasel.
Are we sure it was the same weasel? I mean, it could have been a couple of them.
Did you ever figure out how he got in?
Yeah. I finally found out he was coming up through the dryer vent.
Uh-huh.
Which is probably 30 feet. From, you know, to the washer dryer.
Well, the good news is you didn't have any lint in there that could have started a house fire, because apparently it was just it was smooth sailing. I didn't know we had weasels in Washington State, to be honest with you. I don't know much about the weasel.
Everywhere? I really don't know much about it. I know what they look
like.
They look cute.
I don't know. Yeah, I'm with Miles. Cute. I just started reading it, too. Like, there's a reason you call people weasels.
Yeah, I was going to say, they don't have a great reputation.
Mischievous?
Mischievous? Yeah.
Yeah, I mean, that's kind of like what weasels do. They just sneak around, sneak into places.
And then aren't ferrets related to weasels?
They
I
are.
Assume they are, right?
Right. But that's the thing they're saying. It's like, people have ferrets as pets, not the, weasels.
Not weasels, okay.
I once woke up and blank was going on. 206-803-ROCK.
I got your pet weasel, baby. Hello, Jared. Welcome to the men's room.
Hola.
Hola.
But yes, it looks like they're just all over our country.
Okay. Weasels everywhere.
Way back when, this was, 1999, this was Denver, Colorado, summer of, so we know what was happening earlier in the year, and
right.
My high school was a sister school to that school, and I had friends in that school, so...
Did you go to Cherry Creek?
Connect. No, I was a Green Mountain kid.
Ah, okay.
Yeah, up on the hill. So, idiot kid, stupid driving, I happen to have house arrest for way too long back in the day. And my parents thought it was great that, we're going to Alaska while you're on house arrest. Guess who threw a month-long kegger? And, as the story says, I woke up one night, the night before 4th of July that year, and, we were tying a few on, friends weren't being too much of idiots, and I passed out on the front couch, and I got bang, bang, bang on the front door, wake up, and I startle when I wake up. I'm like, what the heck is going on? Go to the door, and there's, I'm inside of a city, but we're unincorporated, so they have to send sheriffs out to us, which takes even longer.
Right.
And there's a sheriff at my door, and they're like, what's going on? We have reports of this, that, and I'm like, I don't know. I just woke up. I'm on house arrest. I fell asleep on the couch after I worked. Well, come to find out, all my friends were, lighting off fireworks, and how the cops get called for that.
Yeah, of course.
Oh, yeah. So they went around, shut everything off, so it looked like I was really what I stated. Well, the next day, let's just say three kegs later, about $800 worth of fireworks. Midday through the day, we had a cop show up. Everyone got the warning. We tossed all the cups, tried to trash, and we're all hiding out trying to be quiet. And I happened to, people on the roofs in the day, and I was watching the cop. He hopped my fence, and we won't talk about that because he had no reason to do it. And he comes around, he's looking around, sees everything. He knows there's 100-plus parties, something's going on. Opens the door, sees the fireworks. Opens one door, sees at least one keg. He's like, where's the owner? Everyone's pointing to top of the deck. And I'm sitting there, just cross-legged on the edge. Like, oh, hi, officer. Oh, yeah, you got some good surveillance out there for what's going on? Oh, yeah, you know it. All right, I know what it's like to be a teenager. No one drives away drunk, and I'm the idiot, half-lit. And he's just like, I'll be keymaster. He's like, oh, dear God. He's like, all right, I don't want to hear anything else from you guys. Well, you can imagine the rest. We had a friend who was a fire blower. I got to kick a guy. Well, not kick a guy out, but I found out he was packing, and someone told me, and I told him nicely, no, put your gun away. This is a party. Don't need your gun here. Don't bring your guns to town,
Yeah, Wyatt Earp.
And in the night, I was tripping balls. More fireworks were going, and then, I don't know, I was trying to pass out, and some idiot friends were lighting fireworks, throwing it down by my window, and you can imagine how that felt, but...
Okay, that was riveting.
Tara Daly from the Daily Mix Morning Show joining us. We'll sit and spin. We got the 10 worst lyrics in classic rock, and your emails on the way next from the men's room at KISW.com.
My 13-year-old acts like a puppy again. Almost overnight, she's a different dog.
Perfect poops.
When people switch their dog's food to the farmer's dog, the effects can seem like magic. But there's no magic involved. It's simply real meat and vegetables with all the nutrients dogs need instead of highly processed pellets. No tricks, just smarter, healthier pet food delivered in packs portioned for your dog. It's amazing what real food can do. Get 50% off your first order at thefarmersdog.com/nomagic.
Listening to your favorite podcast? That's smart. Earning your degree online from Southern New Hampshire University? That's really smart. With 24/7 access to coursework, no set class times, and dedicated student support, you can go to school when and where it works for you. Low online tuition means you can even do it for less. and dedicated student support means we'll be with you from day one to graduation and beyond. Join a community of learners just like you. Go to snhu.edu today to start your free application.
From executive producer Jimmy Kimmel.
What's up, team? Just two people can't launch a brand. It takes a village.
We are MMD Hollywood.
Wowee.
Which stands for medical marijuana.
Due to restrictions, we can't tell you everything about our new reality series. But what we can say is the idea behind it is fully baked.
I don't know.
High Hopes. Streaming 420 on Hulu.
This episode is brought to you by Allianz Travel Insurance. Are you planning two or more trips in the next 365 days? An all-trips annual travel insurance plan can protect all your adventures for less. Get a quote at AllianzTravelInsurance.com.
My 13-year-old acts like a puppy again. Almost overnight, she's a different dog.
Perfect poops.
When people switch their dog's food to the farmer's dog, the effects can seem like magic. But there's no magic involved. It's simply real meat and vegetables with all the nutrients dogs need instead of highly processed pellets. No tricks, just smarter, healthier pet food delivered in packs portioned for your dog. It's amazing what real food can do. Get 50% off your first order at thefarmersdog.com/nomagic.
Listening to your favorite podcast? That's smart. Earning your degree online from Southern New Hampshire University? That's really smart. With 24/7 access to coursework, no set class times, and dedicated student support, you can go to school when and where it works for you. Low online tuition means you can even do it for less. And dedicated student support means we'll be with you from day one to graduation and beyond. Join a community of learners just like you. Go to snhu.edu today to start your free application.
From executive producer Jimmy Kimmel.
What's up, team? Just two people can't launch a brand. It takes a village.
We are MMD Hollywood.
Wowee.
Which stands for medical marijuana.
Due to restrictions, we can't tell you everything about our new reality series. But what we can say is the idea behind it is fully baked.
I don't know.
High Hopes. Streaming 420 on Hulu.
What's up? It's your boy, The Ted Smith from The Men's Room. And did you know I have a podcast? Well, I do. The Podcast. New episodes uploaded every Wednesday on the Odyssey app.
The debauchery rolls on. You're listening to The Men's Room with Miles and Thrill. 99.9 KISW.
Sin Spin coming up. We have the 10 worst lyrics in classic rock. But first time for a few emails from the men's room at KISW.com.
You've got mail.
You've
got mail.
And a couple from our question. I once woke up and blank was going on. Guys, I got woken up by the police while I was sleeping in my bed. Ex-wife saw them walking down the driveway, let them in the house. She didn't even wake me up. Evidently, she was pissed at me. Peace, guys. That from Raymond, the transplant from Klamath Falls, Oregon.
He's talking about the band.
There's more to the story.
Yeah, what led up to that, right?
Oh, just the cops. Just they walk up my driveway every single night, and no one lets them in. So I don't know what she was thinking.
But they just go away. Yeah,
they just walk up because there was nothing going on. You know,
we're just gonna walk up to your house, see if you let us in.
I can't think of the damn lyric.
Well, like a police song.
I'll be watching you.
Yeah, right. That's what I was like. There's got to be something.
Just
right,
random, random cops walking up your driveway.
I mean, look, that can happen.
Sure.
But, right, the fact that your wife just got up and left because she was pissed, there's no ending to that story.
Yeah, exactly.
And you lived in Klamath Falls.
Yeah. Guys, I was about 12 years old. It was bedtime, so I wrapped the candy cane I was enjoying to save for the next day and placed it on my nightstand. I woke up because I felt something on my arm. The entire nightstand, as well as my bed next to the nightstand, covered in a blanket of carpenter ants.
Ah.
I wouldn't sleep in my room for weeks. That from the lovely Nancy. Years ago, guys, I was in school to become an esthetician. Two of us in class qualified for a full ride, one-year scholarship to a sister school in Australia.
Nice.
She had cats. I had a two-year-old. Oh. So I took her cats, and she went to Australia. Well, one of the cats was quite the hunter. The summer that I had cats, I would sleep with my window cracked open a bit. Landlords were too cheap to put screens in the windows. One night, I wake up in the middle of the night to the hunter cat bapping something on my bed. I woke up, turned on the bed-type label, bed table light, Saw the biggest damn Gardner snake I've ever seen. Very alive. Very pissed off. This damn cat was so proud of himself, I was not amused. R.I.P. there, Bubba Noto, the great orange hunter. That from Rose
Bubba
at
Noto.
One Woman Spa in Tacoma. As we move on to the birthdays, Ola guys, my son is 16. He listens to y'all religiously, for which I can't complain. Please wish him the happiest of birthdays with a fish sandwich and a little bit of advice from Coach Ted. I appreciate y'all. That from Abby.
Too early to get a fish sandwich?
Any advice there on, Miles?
Well,
started 16?
She asked for the dirty Germans, but we don't do dirty Germans for anybody who's not 18 years old.
All right,
so I figured Coach 16? Ted could give some advice on being 16.
All right, you're not going to want to hear this, but trust me, you will get in an accident. So drive carefully. I did, and it might not be a major one, but you'll bump into something, this or that. So I'm telling you, even though you feel like you want to drive fast, do not do it. All right, people that start driving within a year, they're going to hit something.
Oh, I'm trying to think, maybe 3 months, 4 months into my license?
Before, yeah.
Total car. Completely total.
Doesn't take
I mean,
long.
It was so fast. I just got this.
Gone.
Yeah, one of the guys that used to teach math and coach baseball, DeMatha, he also taught driving ed, right? But he knew my family. So I asked him something about a license, and he's like, Teddy, don't sweat it. Doesn't matter how old you are. The first year you learn to drive, he's like, you're going to hit. Like, he gave me the percentage, but he's like, you're going to hit something.
Yep. It's a guarantee, man.
Macholos, yes, it's that time of the year again. It's Robin's 54th trip around the sun. Still keeping the smiles at the Bothell Florist. Working us all very hard. She loves the show, and next time you guys are in the North End partying, she'll bring you all flowers. Thanks. Can we get an owl hitting the window, a suck-it-up cupcake, and Coach Ted telling her she needs more shots at the bar? Thanks, guys, and keep on rocking the Pacific Northwest from Mad Jack and the gang.
I mean, they're right. Look at your birthday, all right? You're 54. What do you got to lose? What, do you got to go in tomorrow? What, are the plants going to be angry at you? Nah, they're flowers. You know how to cut these stems. You've been doing it for years. Everybody in Bothell knows you're the best florist there is. So you go out tonight, you do a shot. They offer you a second shot, you go, eh, think about it. And you keep playing that game until they buy all the shots you want.
Not a bad call. Not a bad call at all. All right, guys, here you go.
Happy birthday to you. Yaws of Dirty Germans brought to you by Men's Room Original Sausage. Available through Uli's World Famous Sausage, mensroomlive.com, and other fine retailers. Schweinefleisch.
Thank you, Robin. We appreciate it. We have some locations we've just found out about with the Men's Room IPA from Black Raven Brook.
Real quick, an update. You can go to the KISW.com website, and you can order the shirts with the logo, cool shirts. We did not know that. Yesterday, we told you, you can also go there and find the beer locations. No, you can't. They are not up there.
No, but I have a few of them.
You do have a few, but we're going to get on Castle to make sure they do get up there, hopefully by the end of the week.
So okay, let's see here. Norm's in Lake Stevens just got Men's Room IPA today. Six packs and singles are available there.
Big shout out to Norm's. They have been a massive supporter since we first started years ago.
Yeah, man, and I guess they just got it today. I went to the selling singles as well.
Norm's a good market, too.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, some of the local locations, hopefully near you in your area. We have the Lucky Market Grocery, the Cathcart's Grocery, Lighthouse Market, the IGA in Darrington, the Superfood Store, Union 76 in Kirkland, Northwest Liquor and Wine in Monroe, Crossroads Market, and Car Wash, AMPM on 124th Avenue Northeast, the QFC in Holman, the Chevron at Dash Point, Brookside Grocer, the Corner Store in Tacoma, Total Wine in Linwood, the A1 Hop Shop, on 104th. A couple Safeway locations, Mukilteo and Aurora. Also the MC Market. That is in Beacon Hill. Fryland 76. Safeway in Kingsgate. Safeway in Linwood. Safeway on Roosevelt Way. The Arbor Center Chevron. Rucker AMPM. The Skymart Shell. Total Wine in Bellevue. The Safeway at Thrasher's Corner. But wait, these are just a partial list and there's more. The Michigan Street Shell. The Market Basket on Walnut Street. The Chevron in Ballinger. The Lake Sawyer Grocer. Safeway in Everett. Echo Falls Food Mart and Liquor.
Echo.
The Safeway Everett. Total Wine in the International District. The Hagen in Stanwood, or Hagen. The Village Market Thriftway in Ballinger. the Safeway in Mill Creek, the Lucky 7 Grocery in Lacey, Safeway in Silver Firs, Safeway in East Bremerton, Safeway in Snohomish, Safeway in Marysville, Safeway on Rucker Avenue, Safeway in Bellevue Way, just about any Safeway location.
Yeah, someone here
carries the beer.
Safeway in Bonnie Lake, as well as the Total Wine in Tequila. That's coming
and
in over
Total
the
Total Wine in Puyallup as well.
Tequila.
Again, there are many more locations out there that carry the beer. That is just a partial list. We'll keep trying to bring as many to you as possible. And if you can, and you find the beer, please shoot us an email to the men's room at KISW.com, and we will get out as many of the grocers and bars in the area that carry the men's room IPA from Black Raven Brewing. Also, don't forget, Friday, March the 15th, we'll be doing our show live from the Black Raven Brewery and Tap House in Woodinville. It is the first stop on the Men's Room World Tour for 2024, and we're launching the Men's Room IPA, and hope you can join us for an afternoon of drinking beer and hanging out at the brewery.
That is perfect.
For a very good time. Speaking of drinking, we will drink coming up with the shot of the day, but first...
Yes, friends, it's time once again for Sit and Spin. Let's gather around the old radio and listen to some swellerific new music.
Oh, look who it is, the lovely Taryn Daly from the Daily Migs Morning Show.
Only one half of the Daily Migs Morning Show.
Yes, we see that. The better
daily part.
Well, Steve Migs, rightfully so, is a... finding out if his daughter's going to need surgery on her broken arm tomorrow.
Oh, well,
God, that's, yeah.
It's enough that your kid breaks a bone. You go, all right, like, please don't need surgery on top of this.
For sure.
Can't
so at some point,
in a cast?
We don't know if we're going to be live tomorrow morning yet or not. I'm planning to show up.
Trampoline.
But if Steve is not there, it's because his daughter's having surgery
what
tomorrow morning.
Trampoline injury? What happened?
So I think it was called the Wiggle Room or something like that.
The Wiggle
which
Room.
I'm like, would also be a great name for a strip club.
Oh, yeah. Yeah,
for, like
yeah, for,
kids,
yeah, for women.
It was like a kid's play area in the mall, I want to say.
All right.
And she fell off of something and broke like the upper arm, like the humerus,
oh,
I believe it is.
Oh, man.
And,
well, that's not very humorous at all.
Not at all. Nobody's laughing. I feel terrible. So hopefully she doesn't need surgery, but if she does, the Daily Mix Show will be on a day off tomorrow.
Okay.
All right.
Well, that's
the wiggle
room. Hey, look, you know, whenever you hear something about a kid, you just hope it's something like surgery on an arm. Okay. That's a terrible place to have a
better
break.
Better than a disease.
Yeah.
Right?
Better totally. Than any that's weird it. Thing that can happen, as you know. And your kid went to school.
Today was his first day.
The first day of school ever. And you missed it.
I missed it because of the snow.
Oh, there's only one first day at school.
We took the day off. We took the day off so I could take him to his new school, and then it snowed a couple inches, and they canceled his school.
So you're already yesterday.
Well, yeah.
It's probably better that you weren't there.
That's what
my
I
experience
said.
With the kids, anyway, day one, if mom is with them, getting them to disattach from mom to going to the school. But the fact you had someone else do it, they're like, all right, peace.
Yep, the nanny texted this morning, said he did great, and he was already making friends.
Okay.
So I feel good about that.
Did he have an outfit?
Yeah, of course he had an outfit.
Okay, no, he went naked, mom.
No, like, what I'm saying is it's
cool
the first day.
Pants.
First day of school, yes. It's the first
it was
day
like
of school
a,
wearing
like
outfit.
A striped shirt that had some camo on it, some gray sneakers. He was looking
all
so
new,
cool.
Right?
All brand new.
See, well, first day of
look
school.
Look at that fly guy.
And you know, he's been going to this outdoor school for the last 2 years.
Which,
so all he's been wearing is like bog boots and rain bibs and outerwear, so he actually gets to look like a kid.
What
now.
Did he do wrong to deserve that? I mean, outdoor school in the Pacific Northwest.
I know those kids are resilient.
Do you hate him?
No,
I mean,
I just want to teach him to be resilient.
All right, I mean, I spend 4 hours outside playing golf, and I'm miserable. It's cold and rainy.
It
and
is.
How do you read a book when it's raining sideways?
You get one of the ones that's for the bath. You know, like a bath book.
When he comes home, does he warm up? Does he just sit by the fire?
Yeah.
Okay.
And he's
kind
of an outdoor.
Books,
yeah, he is an outdoor.
He's an outdoor kid to begin with.
Oh, all right.
They have bath books.
Bath
like
is
a waterproof,
like waterproof
book.
Yeah.
Do you have a little kiddie door where he can go in and go out?
No, he figured out how to unlock our doors so fast. So we had to get these little gates on our deck that you can lock so that we can like lock him from going off the deck.
Okay. He liked the new teacher.
Yes, he loves the new teacher. We're very excited.
And he got a backpack.
Yes.
Does he get like a trapper keeper? Do they still have stuff like that? I mean, what do you need? Pencils?
You know what
they need your first
they had
crayons?
Us build like an emergency kit. So this kid is now more prepared for an earthquake at school than I am at my own house.
Oh, I thought you meant like a defibrillator and an EpiPen.
Yeah. Where's your spot to hide?
Oh,
you have,
I
got it figured
under
out.
Under a table, I guess.
Under the table.
I don't know.
All right.
Under a table.
Okay.
Is it doorway?
Doorway. Yeah.
Yeah.
Door
I don't know. I saw my kid. Dude, just do what I do and scream.
I would get under that table in your kitchen.
That big ass table. I just dive over that, man, and save it all for yourself. You know, you guys find your own spot.
Oh, yeah.
Because I'm tall. You know what I mean? All right. So today,
good luck.
Right. Today, we're going to talk about just some odd lyrics that have have happened in classic rock or rock songs throughout the years. Just things that maybe rhymed for whatever reason, but ultimately they just didn't make any sense or were stupid.
Yeah.
I think stupid is generally how it goes. I always quote Gene Simmons, who had the line, "I want to put my log in your fireplace." And like, look, we get what you're saying. You couldn't think of anything more poetic than that.
That was the best alliteration.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. They bring up Kid Rock, American Badass. You know that song. And I'm back with the beaver hats and Ben Davis slacks. 30-pack of Strohs, 30-pack of hose, no Rogaine, and the propane flows.
Yeah. All right. I'm assuming speaking of poetic.
Is he grilling? What's going on?
Poet laureate in the making.
Right, exactly.
He's not drinking Strohs. Yeah.
I always think about Alice.
That is a terrible beer.
I love Alice in Chains. But when they say, when they sing, we pay our debts on time, I just imagine like they get their cable bill, right? But they pay it right away. You know what I mean?
And they feel good about themselves.
Yeah, exactly. Electric bill, boom. You know, it's not sitting on the counter. You don't get a pink note, whatever.
They're saying they're good roommates.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. These are the 10 worst lyrics in classic rock.
10, number 10.
Ain't got no distractions, can't hear no buzzes and bells. Don't see no lights are flashing, plays by sense of smell. Always gets a replay, never seen him fall. That's Deaf, Dumb, and Blind Kid. Sure plays a
mean. Also, like, in 2024, we don't say Deaf, Dumb, and Blind Kid anymore. We just don't say
not
that.
Not to their face.
No.
That's a lot.
So the lyric in question here is that he plays by sense of smell.
Oh, right. Not the deaf, dumb, blind kid.
No. But I do like, I see, do like I'd a supple wrist. Supple wrist is very important.
He plays pinball with his sense of smell. That's okay. Yeah. I just assume he's not very good.
Yeah. I would assume that Steve the Thrill Hill has a very supple wrist.
I was going to say, how was your
night?
How was your
wrist?
Very supple wrist.
Well, thank you. Mm-hmm. You know, no one comments on my supple wrist. I appreciate you.
Well, I just feel like I know enough about what you do in your free time to know that your wrist is very supple.
10 worst lyrics in classic rock.
Number 9.
Who counts the money?
Ooh.
I'm underneath the bar. Who rides the wrecking ball into our guitars?
What does that even mean?
Who rides the wrecking ball into our guitars, Starship? What does that even mean?
Starship kind of lost its mind toward the end there, I think.
I mean, if it was Miley Cyrus riding the wrecking ball,
that's my first thought.
That'd be awesome. Different. I would understand.
Because she's doing construction.
Yeah.
Maybe she wrote that song so that they didn't seem as stupid when they wrote this lyric.
She fixed it for me.
Yeah. I think it's obvious they're destroying the guitar. listen to that riff,
dude. Demolition for a summer. 10 worst lyrics in classic rock.
8. Number 8.
Hypodermics on the shore. China's under martial law. Rock and roll and cola wars. I can't take it.
Did you hear what I heard?
I heard that.
It's China.
Oh.
China.
Okay, I misunderstood what he was saying.
Seems simple. There's people doing dope on the beach and China.
Do any of you know how tall Billy Joel is?
Oh, we just did this. He's like 5'7", I think.
Shorter.
5'5".
I think he's 5'5", which is how tall I am. But I'm wearing some very tall boots today, so I'm actually taller than Billy Joel.
What did
today.
He say there?
He says, rock and roller cola wars, I can't take it anymore.
What about the Regina? Is he Canadian?
That I don't know.
China.
10 worst lyrics in classic rock.
7, number 7.
One man out of luck, one so scares me. That logic ties me up and wrecks me.
Ooh.
Okay. Is this the part?
What's the lyric?
It is, and when their eloquence escapes me, their logic ties me up and rapes me.
Ooh.
Wow,
is
man.
Is that worse than the do-do-do, da-da-da-da? That's all I've got to say to you? Because I'm voting for that.
Yeah, that was my thought.
So, like, he only hooks up with smart chicks if they hold him down?
She's
got a brain on her.
10 worst lyrics in classic rock.
6, number 6.
I've been through the desert on a horse with no name.
I mean, even just reading that, in the desert. desert, you can remember your name because there ain't no one for to give you no pain.
My guess is acid.
Clearly.
Meanwhile, the horse is like, my name's Jeff. Why am I in the desert? It's hot.
Wait, did he even ask what the horse's name was?
You never asked.
Does it matter what his name is?
No, he had no name. That's what the whole point is.
Right.
But don't you need to know his name to get him to go places?
Hey, you, come here.
Come on, thing.
Mike, I remember being like 19, sitting in a restaurant with my buddy, and the song's on, and I go, why is he in the desert on a horse with no name?
Right.
Like, it's never made sense.
Why is he in the desert on a horse? The horse is like, how about a camel, dumbass, like everyone else?
Or give the horse a name.
And why is the horse having no name of any importance at all? I don't give a damn.
Why did you bring it up, man?
Right, I don't give a damn what your name is. Get me across a friggin' desert.
Did somebody ask you the horse's name? Nobody cares. Now I'm all worked up.
Five, number five. I've been in trouble since I don't know when. I'm in trouble.
Contradictory. I'm a loner, but I'm never alone.
How about the fact that he's a dirty white boy?
Yeah.
Again, I'm voting for that. What do you think he's into? What is his fetish?
Name it.
He's a dirty white boy.
Saying that.
Dirty white
stuff.
Subscribes to many.
Boy, like small fingers.
His fetish is methamphetamine. That's why he's always in trouble.
Or he might just not bathe.
10 worst lyrics in classic rap.
Number four.
Sleeping Bag by ZZ Top.
Mm-hmm.
Let's go out to Egypt because it's in the plan. And then whatever those other lyrics were. Then he goes into, we'll whip out our mattress because there ain't no beds.
Hmm. So you I did not know that about Egypt.
No beds in Egypt.
It's a good travel tip.
It's in the plan.
Why are you saying I'm going to whip out my mattress if the name of the song is Sleeping Bag?
Yeah.
Just how much luxury? That's glamping, dude.
10 worst lyrics in classic rock.
Number three. Mama's come out.
This is a kick-ass tune, though.
I liked all the songs, even if they're stupid.
If you missed it, it says, mountains come out of the sky, and they stand there.
They come out of the sky, not
the
ground.
They do, not the ground.
Oh, they come from the top.
Yeah.
And they stand there.
Contrary to popular opinion about mountains.
Damn, all those years of school and MML.
Yes. This is a great, the bass line in this is so sick.
Oh, this is one of the best bass lines ever.
Dirty.
Can you play that?
Of course I can.
Can you?
Oh, yeah. That's one of those. If you're a bass, you know, everyone else wants to play Stairway if you're a guitar player, whatever the hell they care about. But, yeah, this is one of the bass lines.
Damn.
You absolutely want to do, man.
Next mission for the new originals.
8.5 minutes. You're singing it.
Yeah. 10 worst lyrics in classic rock.
Number two.
Just a city boy. Born and raised in South Detroit.
Which would be Windsor, Ontario.
No, that'd be North Detroit. Or would that be South?
No, Windsor, that part of Canada is the way, south the way of Detroit. Windsor.
So there is no South Detroit.
Yes, that would be a different country.
Mm.
I'll be damned.
Yeah, there's job, downtown, because downtown's like your southern border, and then if you go south, you go to Canada, buddy. Right.
Then they turn into Triumph.
Just say I'm a Canadian.
10 more lyrics in classic rock with minutes to number one.
Number one.
That's redundant.
I mean, he's not wrong.
No.
Only time will tell if we stand the test of time.
It's kind of a banger. Turn it up.
Deep.
Yeah. I like some Van Halen.
I love Van Halen. I will always unapologetically tell you about how much I love that
song. This song kicks ass. Thank you so much, Taryn. We appreciate
thank you guys.
It. Daily Migs, 6 to 10, maybe just the Daily Show tomorrow.
We're going
to
find out.
It is a Daily Show.
Show of the day is on the way. You are listening to The Men's Room.
My 13-year-old acts like a puppy again. Almost overnight, she's a different dog.
Perfect poops.
When people switch their dog's food to the farmer's dog, the effects can seem like magic. But there's no magic involved. It's simply real meat and vegetables with all the nutrients dogs need instead of highly processed pellets. No tricks, just smarter, healthier pet food delivered in packs portioned for your dog. It's amazing what real food can do. Get 50% off your first order at thefarmersdog.com/nomagic.
From executive producer Jimmy Kimmel.
What's up, team? Just two people can't launch a brand. It takes a village.
We are MMD Hollywood.
Wowee.
Which stands for medical marijuana.
Due to restrictions, we can't tell you everything about our new reality series. But what we can say is the idea behind it is fully baked. High Hopes. Streaming 420 on Hulu.
Listening to your favorite podcast? That's smart. Earning your degree online from Southern New Hampshire University? That's really smart. With 24/7 access to coursework, no set class times, and dedicated student support, you can go to school when and where it works for you. Low online tuition means you can even do it for less. And dedicated student support means we'll be with you from day one to graduation and beyond. Join a community of learners just like you. Go to snhu.edu today to start your free application.
This episode is brought to you by Allianz Travel Insurance. When you're far from home, anything can happen. That's why more than 70 million American travelers trust Allianz Travel Insurance to protect their adventures. With benefits for medical emergencies and evacuations, trip cancellations, travel delays, and baggage mishaps, you can travel with perfect peace of mind. Learn more and get a quote at AllianzTravelInsurance.com.
99.9 KISW. The shenanigans continue. This is the Men's Room with Miles and Thrill.
All right, check out all drinking toasts with a shot of the day. And we do have your headlines on the way at 5:50. But first, quick check in with Mike Hawk. Some of the stories and headlines he is not working on.
Thank you, Miles. A zoo in Tampa has an encounter that allows people to swim with stingrays.
Okay. Would you do it?
Technically speaking, the reason why everybody shouldn't have happened in the first place.
Steve Irwin?
Yeah. They tend to be decently docile and just for whatever reason decided not to be in that moment. But however, no.
I've stepped on one a couple times. That's kind of weird.
Yeah. It's a little weird.
I had 2 feet on it. So like when I was a kid, I was younger, the Gulf of Mexico, I was digging my feet into the ground for sand dollars, which turns the bottom of your feet completely green.
Yes.
And I was out probably 100 feet, and I was just walking out there, and there was a sandbar that I could see that was shallower, but there was a lower dip.
Yeah.
So when I went that lower dip, like I kind of sunk down, and I landed right on top of one, and my feet kicked out from under me, and I looked up, and there was this big thing swimming away, and I was like, wow.
Get your feet off me, kid.
That's crazy.
I think it's here at the Seattle Aquarium that has like a touch tank that you can touch the stingrays or big man rays or whatever they are.
Touching one is different than swimming with them.
Right. And they're not, it's not like we're prey for them.
Right.
I think you just swim around and they would swim around you.
Exactly.
Like, I don't know that it's that exciting.
Right. Right.
Swimming with a shark, you're like, all right, it's a shark.
There's an adrenaline rush there, for sure.
Right. Kind of like swimming with turtles. Now, I thought that was really cool when I found a turtle on a beach of Hawaii. At the end of the day, when you look at it objectively, it's boring. He just floated about there.
I was hoping Woodland Park Zoo would start, and I've sent them this idea a million times, walking with lions. Mike, look, you can swim with stingrays. Why can't we just get into the enclosure and hang out with the lion for a little while?
I've seen that enclosure a couple times. I look at the thing like, they can jump that.
I know, man. I'm telling you. After that deal in San Francisco, just to remind people, this was 15, 16 years ago, it was Christmas Day, the San Francisco Zoo. Kids had a slingshot that kept hitting the tiger with it.
Yeah.
And I want to say the wall was like 20 feet tall, and there's a moat between the mainland where the tiger is and the wall. So these kids, obviously, are 20 feet above it, across a moat, keep hitting it with the slingshot, and they leap.
Right.
They didn't get a running start. It leaped out of its enclosure. And mess the kids up. Didn't kill them, but mess the kids up pretty bad.
Yeah,
and we got a moat. After hearing that, I'm like, man, I feel a lot less comfortable.
And we got a moat and a little, hip-high, not even fence.
Yeah, brother, trust me.
They're coming.
If they want to snatch you out of there, they could.
Pittsburgh area naturalists are hosting a bowling event that allows players, you guessed it, to play in the nude.
Okay. I always thought to myself, you know what would make bowling more fun? If we could do it naked.
Right.
With shoes.
You still have to wear shoes.
You want that slide.
Yeah.
So, I mean, that's kind
that
of the funny thing.
That makes it worse.
If you're a nudist, you probably spend a decent amount of time nude with just shoes.
Yeah.
Walking around the property.
It's still nasty on your feet, right?
Yeah, I would just think you'd still wear shoes a decent amount.
Yeah.
And I'm nude, but I still got to do the lawn.
Exactly. Just getting a tan. Miami Beach is reportedly attempting to, quote, break up with spring break.
They are. They're going after him hard.
They're trying. It's not going to work, but yeah, they're trying. They've been doing this for 3 years.
There's other towns. This is like whack-a-mole of Florida.
Right. It's just, they're coming to your state.
They might say, no more Panama Beach. Push that down. Then they'll come back 2 years later. Mm-hmm. And then they just kind of, everybody just kind of drifts to a new location. Key West is still an asylum. You can go there and do whatever you want any time of the year, and no one cares.
But there's also the flip side of the story. You know, they're saying the state of Florida, or the city of Miami, Miami Beach specifically, we want to do away with this. But when you talk to business owners there, they're like, no, we don't. We make goo gobs of money in a couple of weeks. We understand kids are going to be kids. They get in fights. They do the thing. But they also spend a lot of money.
I mean, that's one of those things, like, is it being the old guy when you're like, it seems like it's gotten crazier? Or is it just because we can see it?
It might be because we can see it. Because social media, you can post, you know, every massive fight that happens there. But to your point, Ted, I bet you if you went back 40 years, there's the same number of fights with the same number of people. We just don't see it. You're not in
it. It depends on the municipality. Some areas you cannot take alcoholic beverages on the beach.
Right.
Some you can. So it just depends on where you are. The most ideal situation to be in is one, obviously, where you don't get busted because you got a cooler drinking beers on the beach.
Exactly. Talked all day about things that people woke up to, and a place that people tend to wake up, at least on a fairly regular basis, is their own bed.
Yeah.
And some people wake up to find some strange things under their bed. In fact, I've got an entire list.
The Men's Room Top 10.
I already don't like this.
Yeah, you don't.
The Men's Room Top
10 of the strangest things found under beds. Well, I already told you the tale of finding my brother's handcrafted Bishop Buffer. How about when I was days away from driving cross-country to begin this illustrious and oh-so-rewarding career with these fine pillars of society? I was the proud parent of an adopted older cat. When I awoke one morning, he was nowhere to be found. After scouring my place, I looked under the bed. There he was. Spread eagle, stiff as a board, dead as a doornail.
Yeah.
Apparently, he didn't like road trips.
Damn.
I did not know. Is that real?
Yeah, it is real.
Oh, I didn't know his cat died right after that.
Yeah. He talked to me about what he found, and it was...
Oh, God.
Yeah. It was bad. So these are 10 of the strangest things that people have found under their beds.
Sorry, VD. Like, good thing you brought them.
Oh,
Jesus.
I
mean, at that point, just leave them.
Bottoming out the list is not anything in particular, but they have a spray that gets rid of monsters under your bed.
Oh, good idea. Ah, for the kids.
Yeah.
I always told my kid there's no monsters under your bed. Are demons in the wall, but there are no monsters under your bed.
It should be spider killer.
This spray.
I mean, in theory, any spray could be a monster spray.
Correct. Get some Lysol.
If you tell them.
Febreze. It kills monsters.
Yeah.
They finally got rid of that smells. Big ugly red spider in my house.
Oh, yeah.
Finally caught that bug.
God,
he's...
Let's see here. They named this one the poltergeist that terrorized a couple turned out to be a meth head. Sometimes there really is a boogeyman on the bed. Just ask Brian O'Neill and his wife Bridget, who returned to their Seattle condo late one night in July to discover their clothes scattered everywhere, electronics piled up high on their bed. Strangest of all, the soles from 20 pairs of shoes have been removed. Nothing had been stolen save for $50 in cash. A couple called police. They found nothing, not even fingerprints. Let's see here. Right after police left, they called him again. This time they heard noises coming from under their bed. When police returned, they didn't find a monster, but a meth addict under the woman's, meth addicted woman under the bed.
Jesus, man.
Hiding for hours.
That's a very Seattle story.
That very Seattle.
Pretty
guy.
Seattle story there. Strangest things that people have found under their beds. The world's most valuable violin spent 5 decades underneath a bed.
What?
Yeah. A 274-year-old violin is also it's also the most valuable in the world, recently selling for an estimated $16 million. The anonymous new donor unselfishly realized that the musical instrument was best kept in the hands of world-renowned violinists that I can't say their name.
Yeah, I was going to say Russian?
Or
Italian,
probably.
Is it? I feel like good violinists come from the...
Get a lot of Eastern Bloc kind of countries. Mm-hmm. Yeah.
There was a landlord that discovered almost $1 million underneath the bed of an ex-tenant.
Hmm. Why would anyone know that?
Right?
If I found $1 million in cash, I assume, under the bed, like, no one's going to know.
They found 6.33 million Chinese yuan in cash left behind in boxes. Been there for several years. It simply disappeared and stopped paying the rent. When he was cleaning the apartment, he found the box underneath the bed.
I like that he stopped paying the rent. Like, you had $6 million in cash, and you're like, nah, I can't be bothered.
Which I understand. I don't quite know how the exchange rate's going to go. You're not going to get all of your money as you exchange it, but you have... It even shows it was like $892,000 American in Chinese cash.
Actually, when my grandparents died on my mom's side, all right, so they'd always been broke, poor, whatever you want to call it, and after they died, all their kids get together, clean out the house, take care of things. My mother calls me from Virginia, and she's like, you know the shoeboxes under your grandparents' bed? I'm like, yeah, I assume there were shoes in. Cash, $95,000 in cash.
Jeez.
I was like, apparently they just put it away like the whole time they were married.
Strangest things that people have found under the bed. In March of 2015, a stranger was knocking on residents' doors in the Cayman Drive area of Palm Springs, Florida. A neighbor watched as the man walked toward the rear of the residence, and they immediately phoned police. Simultaneously, a 61-year-old resident of that very home was looking for her cats when she reached under the bed, and instead of feeling fur, she touched human skin.
God.
Yeah. I'm hiding under the bed. Damn. A woman found a sinkhole under her bed.
Florida.
Guatemala City.
Okay, all right.
Wait a minute. Yes, Guatemala City.
Guatemala City. You acted Guatemala City, brother.
Yeah. Here, man, hit this.
Oh, this one's bad.
I don't know if you have a follow-up. Like, how long, could they tell how long it had been there? Was it a matter of time before the whole bed sunk?
Oh, it's a matter of time before, she goes down, man. God.
She woke to the sound of a loud explosion one morning in July 2011. Originally thought that it was sound caused by a cooking gas tank explosion or a car outside. And after peeking out to see what the noise originated from, a neighbor told her that the loud noise came from inside of her house. She soon discovered, to her horror, a 3-foot-wide, 40-foot-deep sinkhole beneath her bed.
Yeesh. That makes a lot more sense.
Yeah.
40 feet deep.
How about this one? It says, you might have heard the story of a couple checking into a hotel room putting up with a foul stench and ultimately finding a decomposed body underneath the bed in the room. Yeah, that exactly happened.
I think that might be the place that Miles and I have to stay when we do a live day.
Yeah. God. Good times. Number two on the list. A man kept Napoleon's penis under his bed.
Jesus Christ.
Yeah.
I mean, if you have Napoleon's penis, is there a better place to put it? I don't know.
Right. In 1821, after Bonaparte died, Dr. Francesco, performed an autopsy for the first emperor of France, removed his liver and his stomach, and placed them in jars of alcohol. The doctor also removed his penis and gave it to the priest in Corsica.
Yeah. Priest is probably
in 1916.
You made things weird, man.
Yeah, thanks, dude.
I have Napoleon's penis.
1977, a urologist living in New Jersey purchased the phallic relic for $3,000 and stored it under his bed until he died 30 years later.
Who do you leave that to?
Oh.
And if you leave it, because it's only $3,000, all right? So it's not like you're going to make a cash cow out of this. Do you leave it to someone you like or someone you don't like?
Right. Gun it.
My father left me Napoleon's penis.
Oh,
thanks.
You know what? You leave that to somebody that you don't like. You get absolutely filthy rich because you spent $3,000 on somebody's tallywhacker. But then what you do is you host this big grand sit down, and I'm going to leave all of my money to Ted, and I'm going to leave my extravagant house to Thrill. And to Miles, my favorite, I leave Napoleon Bonaparte's penis.
And nothing else.
Sweet.
And not another
thing. I don't know
thing.
If you need to do it to be mean, but I'm leaving it to Miles. Because he's the only person that I feel confident would, like, show it off. And show it to people.
Right here.
He would
right?
put it in a
glass of the four
box.
Of us, Miles was most likely to display.
You want to feel better about yourself?
Right. You thought he was short? Look what's short on him.
I got something for you.
You know what I would do? I'd send it to Kelowna Willie.
Clone a Willie?
Have you heard of Clone a Willie?
Yes, I have.
I'd send it to Clone a Willie. Oh, and then just give him a like, this is a little gift for you.
Then when somebody steals it, you can laugh at him. That was the dummy penis.
I should have the real Napoleon penis.
I mean, he's
fool.
Pretty famous. Yeah. I was going to own somebody else's. I guess Napoleon's wouldn't be bad.
Who would you pick? Top pick. They're already dead. They're already gone. Listen, Ted, you have your pick of dead people's penises for your display.
Alexander the Great.
See, I feel like that one, that's a solid one, right?
Or like Genghis Khan.
Ooh, that thing is probably still working.
Yeah, that's right.
I understand.
Careful.
I brought it home. My wife got pregnant.
Hide the women. Ben Franklin.
Ben Franklin. Yeah. All right.
Apparently, that got some work, too, man.
Yeah.
Mr. Hill?
Pick a penis.
Pick a penis.
Pick a penis.
Miles, pick a penis.
How to pick a penis. You know, man,
someone like famous?
Winston Churchill.
You would take Churchill. All right.
A big historical guy. I liked what he had to say.
Okay.
But that penis has seen things.
I'm going like Long Dong Silver.
I have low ceilings.
You're going to get one. Get
right.
one.
But then the strangest thing that has been found underneath the bed, which I don't know how you just kind of happen upon this, but you do. Someone found a crocodile underneath his bed.
Jesus Christ.
Yeah. In 2013, he was spending the night at a Humani ranch in Zimbabwe. And, he slept 8 hours before finding out that he had a croc underneath his bed.
Jesus.
Good times. Two people in North Carolina were arrested for stealing, but you won't believe what they stole, Miles.
What did they steal?
Tell you all about it at 5:50.
Thank you, sir. Headlines are coming up at 5:50. In the meantime, let's get a contestant on the line for Profile. This is 206-803-ROCK. Have we made it to drinking time?
My 13-year-old acts like a puppy again. Almost overnight, she's a different dog.
Perfect poops.
When people switch their dog's food to the farmer's dog, the effects can seem like magic. But there's no magic involved. It's simply real meat and vegetables with all the nutrients dogs need instead of highly processed pellets. No tricks, just smarter, healthier pet food delivered in packs portioned for your dog. It's amazing what real food can do. Get 50% off your first order at thefarmersdog.com/nomagic.
Listening to your favorite podcast? That's smart. Earning your degree online from Southern New Hampshire University? That's really smart. With 24/7 access to coursework, no set class times, and dedicated student support, you can go to school when and where it works for you. Low online tuition means you can even do it for less. And dedicated student support means we'll be with you from day one to graduation and beyond. Join a community of learners just like you. Go to snhu.edu today to start your free application.
From executive producer Jimmy Kimmel.
What's up, team? Just two people can't launch a brand. It takes a village.
We are MMD Hollywood.
Wowee.
Which stands for medical marijuana.
Due to restrictions, we can't tell you everything about our new reality series. But what we can say is the idea behind it is fully baked. High Hopes. Streaming 4/20 on Hulu.
This is a promotional message for Alexia's Sweet Potato Fries. And in the process of elucidating you on all the wondrous virtues Alexia's Sweet Potato Fries have to offer, I intend to do so in a prodigious manner befitting of such a superlative side. That's because all Alexia creations are creatively crafted, from sweet potato fries that accomplish a delicate balance of sweet and savory, without GMOs or superfluous additives, to the eloquent lexicon of her advertisements, like this one. Because every Alexia experience is intended to feel creatively crafted and exceptional without exception. Alexia's sweet potato fries. Do procure them in your grocer's freezer.
My 13-year-old acts like a puppy again. Almost overnight, she's a different dog.
Perfect poops.
When people switch their dog's food to the farmer's dog, the effects can seem like magic. But there's no magic involved. It's simply real meat and vegetables with all the nutrients dogs need instead of highly processed pellets. No tricks, just smarter, healthier pet food delivered in packs portioned for your dog. It's amazing what real food can do. Get 50% off your first order at thefarmersdog.com/nomagic.
From executive producer Jimmy Kimmel.
What's up, team? Just two people can't launch a brand. It takes a village.
We are MMD Hollywood.
Wowee.
Which stands for medical marijuana.
Due to restrictions, we can't tell you everything about our new reality series. But what we can say is the idea behind it is fully baked.
I don't know.
High Hopes. Streaming 4/20 on Hulu.
What's up? It's your boy, The Ted Smith from The Men's Room. And did you know I have a podcast? Well, I do. The Podcast. New episodes uploaded every Wednesday on the Odyssey app.
Somebody out there deserves to be recognized. And The Men's Room knows just who it is. So to you, we say, bottoms up, sailor.
You're the toast of our shot of the day.
Drink time it is, and as usual, we head to the drink desk and Steve a thrill hill to find out who we're toasting.
Yes, indeed. First of all, we open a can of worms. No pun intended. It's people that are not telling us whose penises they would like to have.
Yep.
Historical penis. Somebody wants the Lincoln log, so to speak. Sex penis. Milton Berle. Yes, he was.
Milton Berle.
No, dude, seriously, he was known to have a massive crank back in the day. Like, we saw him as an old man, but apparently, homie could jump rope with that thing, so he's doing all right. All right, today we toast an unidentified man from Philadelphia, Pennsylvania. Now, last week, our honoree entered a jewelry store at a mall, and he approached an employee. He said he had a weapon, and he demanded that the employee, quote, hand over all the jewelry in the case. Well, she didn't have a key, so she called over the manager, who actually began to comply, but was told, hurry up, because she was taking too long, and then he threatened her. Finally, he got too impatient, so he went around the back of the counter to snatch the bag out of her hand. But as he did that, he fell over onto the floor. And that's when mall security, they arrived and they subdued him. You're probably wondering, why are we toasting him? Well, it should be noted, one, he did not have a weapon on him. And also, our honoree, he was in a wheelchair and had no legs.
So when he fell out, he was screwed.
He was a W amputee. Rolled up in a wheelchair, but he said he had the weapon. That's why they tried to comply. So, yeah, when he fell out of his wheelchair on the floor, they're like, it's on you, buddy. Mall security came in. Let's say real easy for them to deal with this guy.
Hard to run with the jewels when you...
It is kind of hard to run with the jewels when you don't have legs. What does that look for, Ted?
Come on, dude.
How bad of an idea it was for him to try to pull this off?
Yeah.
Yeah. Fell out of his chair. All right, so we pour this booze, and we drink this booze because we think it's yummy.
Yummy!
So over the tongue and down the throat to party in our tummies.
Down the hola, bitchola!
The Men's Room presents Profile This.
And Stephen Throwhill, could you please tell everyone how Profile This is played?
I sure can, Miles. It's a simple game where we share with you a real-life news story, something that happened right here on planet Earth. And as you listen to the story, based on the stereotypes you believe to be true of people and the decisions that people make, we'll ask you what it is you think makes the story a story. Today, fellas, you will be competing against each other.
Okay.
All right.
Miles Montgomery, D. Ted Smith, Mike Hawk, all three of you in the game. But as always, you have three categories to choose from. We have interior decorating, where you guess the foreign object that ended up on the inside of someone. Hit me with your best shot. Where you guess the unconventional weapon someone chose to use as a weapon. And finally, animalize this. Where you guess the animal responsible for causing the problem.
Animal?
That's where I was going to, Ted.
All right, a man by the name of Austin.
My instinct was to yell drugs. That's all I was like, oh, it's not an option.
I was wondering what that look was for. Okay. A man by the name of Austin Riley. Now, he has spent years on his family's ranch in Texas in Hill County, caring for and spending time with the animals. Now, in 2017, when an animal's mother died in childbirth, Riley immediately took over, bottle feeding the newborn and letting it sleep inside the family home until the weather got warm enough to move the animal outside. The animal's name, in case you care, was Waylon. And over the next few years, the two were best friends, which is why it came as such a shock one night when Waylon attacked Riley out of nowhere, nearly killing him. Now, Riley, who, as they say, had cheated death a number of times already, he survived the attack, but barely. He said Waylon had never before showed any signs of aggression. He sometimes fell asleep on Riley's chest, and Riley passed hours in Waylon's pen or took him out on drives. Well, 20 minutes before the attack, Waylon had greeted Riley happily as he entered the pen. Now, after feeding another animal in an adjacent pen and then re-entering Waylon's enclosure, Riley suddenly found Waylon coming at him relentlessly. Quote, I can't forget his eyes, the way they were locked in to kill. It's a mystery to this day why Waylon, who was euthanized the next day, turned violent. Now, the question is, what kind of animal was Waylon? Was Waylon a warthog? Was Waylon a rooster? Was Waylon a pig? Or was Waylon a goat? So, warthog, rooster, pig, or goat, what was Waylon?
I'm going rooster, Ted.
Oh, they come to stop the rooster.
I just don't see how a rooster could mess you up that much.
Bro, you got some claws, you bro. Really would be surprised. They're...
Yeah, those talons are no joke, and when they come after you, they can. But I'm with you. I don't know if it would get to the point to where it's like, oh, shoot, he's about to kill me. Also, I don't know what he could feed another animal, because it would just be other chickens that would set him off. I don't know why anybody would have a warthog, but it's speaking to me. So I'm going to go warthog on this one.
Okay.
I'm with you. I'm trying to decide between warthog and goat, but just for the hell of the game, I'll go goat.
Goat.
All right, what was this animal that he raised that ended up attacking him? Was it a warthog, a rooster, a pig, or a goat? We'll find out next.
That was a tease.
My 13-year-old acts like a puppy again. Almost overnight, she's a different dog.
Perfect poops.
When people switch their dog's food to the farmer's dog, the effects can seem like magic. But there's no magic involved. It's simply real meat and vegetables with all the nutrients dogs need instead of highly processed pellets. No tricks, just smarter, healthier pet food delivered in packs portioned for your dog. It's amazing what real food can do. Get 50% off your first order at thefarmersdog.com/nomagic.
Listening to your favorite podcast? That's smart. Earning your degree online from Southern New Hampshire University? That's really smart. With 24/7 access to coursework, no set class times, and dedicated student support, you can go to school when and where it works for you. Low online tuition means you can even do it for less. And dedicated student support means we'll be with you from day one to graduation and beyond. Join a community of learners just like you. Go to snhu.edu today to start your free application.
From executive producer Jimmy Kimmel.
What's up, team? Just two people can't launch a brand. It takes a village.
We are MMD Hollywood.
Wowee.
Which stands for medical marijuana.
Due to restrictions, we can't tell you everything about our new reality series. But what we can say is the idea behind it is fully baked.
I don't know.
High Hopes. Streaming 420 on Hulu.
99.9 KISW. We return to the men's room with Miles and Thrill.
Category is animalized. It's on profile. Let's get a Texas man. He worked on a ranch there, and he took over after an animal who gave birth passed on. Mm-hmm. Baby lived with the mom.
Correct.
Didn't make it through the birth. So he ended up taking care of the newborn. And then as the animal grew older, it got wilder, ended up attacking him. He had to put the animal down.
Yeah, damn near killed him.
Question is, but it was fine up until then. They're buds. So was it a warthog, a rooster, a pig, or a goat?
That's the very question that I posed. You fellas, let us start with, Mr. Miles Montgomery, you went rooster. It was not a rooster.
He ain't going to die.
Ted, you went with the old goat.
Goat.
It was not a goat.
Come on, baby. Give me a warthog.
Mike, like you said, you don't know why anyone would have
a warthog.
The Harry Potter world.
Yeah. But you're correct.
Okay. Very good.
Dude, at a warthog. I don't know how we got a hold of him, but whatever the case.
What a stupid idea.
Stupid idea, because one thing that somebody pointed out, they said, look, it may have been your buddy, but you understand they're designed to fight lions.
Whoa! Oh, yeah. I did not know what that looked like.
And they're brutal. They do not care.
It looks like something from The Lion King.
It is something from The Lion King.
What it's from.
It's
not
most people would know. Jeez, it. Pumbaa.
Okay, then.
But it's Texas. You can have all kinds of animals.
Yes, you can, including a warthog.
And now for all TV news all the time, it's time for TV Time with Ted.
And now, because your pathetic life is confined to countless hours in front of a talking box, the Men's Room presents TV Time with Ted.
All right, your choices today. You got the Jimmys.
Fallon and Kimmel.
Seth Meyers.
Sure.
Stephen Colbert. Writers. Or Ted Smith.
Is it Ted or is it Late Night?
It's right there. The title is Jazz Have Challenge. The teams of writers help them come up with the monologues each and every night. It is up to you to determine, is this an actual late night joke and from whom? Or could it be a The Ted Smith original?
Fox has announced they are releasing a reboot of Baywatch, and now David Hasselhoff plays an old guy on the beach with a metal detector.
Ted Smith.
Writers.
Fallon.
Well, guys, some entertainment news. Fox announced that they're releasing a reboot of Baywatch. Now David Hasselhoff plays the old guy on the beach with a metal detector.
In massive red flag news, a tech worker wore Apple's creepy Vision Pro headset during his wedding photo, much to his wife's dismay. I assume he got them so he'd experience an artificial reality where he is still married.
Myers. Ted.
Colbert.
In massive red flag news, a tech worker wore Apple's creepy Vision Pro headset during his wedding photo, much to his wife's dismay.
I assume he got them so he can experience an artificial reality where he's still married.
A cop in Mississippi was arrested after she stole a pair of shoes from a sporting goods store while in uniform. And this is bad. They took her to jail in her own police car. I guess instead of bring your child to work day, it was bring yourself to work day.
Because we're found.
Smith.
All right. We have one of those today, downtown. Bring your employee to work day. Tuesday, Wednesdays, and Thursdays.
Oh, yeah, that's it.
People show up. That's when the traffic happens.
Oh, yeah, yeah, yeah. Right, and I know, Amazon. I think they all show up on Tuesday or Thursday. One of those days.
Is it? Yeah. Yeah, Monday and Friday, pretty sparse out there.
A man broke a world record by having the most rabbit-themed tattoos. First, he got two, but then they multiplied.
Seth Reiners.
Fallon.
Listen to this. I read about a man who broke a world record for having the most rabbit-themed tattoos. First, he got two, then they multiplied.
Employees at a thrift store in Canada recently discovered a World War II-era grenade hidden in their donations bin. Luckily, since it was a thrift store, they were all able to get a pair of fresh pants.
Fallon, yeah.
Seth.
Employees at a thrift store in Canada recently discovered a World War II-era grenade in their donations bin. Luckily, since it was a thrift store, they were all able to get a fresh pair of pants.
I'm not going to lie. That one took me a second.
Yeah.
And I was like, oh, that's good. They probably did poop their pants. So you heard the joke, but a Baywatch reboot series is in the works at Fox. They haven't said when it's going to come out. They don't even have a cast announced yet, but the official plot description is, quote, daring ocean rescues, pristine beaches, the iconic red bathing suits are back, along with a whole new generation of Baywatch lifeguards who navigate complicated, messy personal lives.
So in other words, Baywatch. Why didn't it say, hey, if you've seen Baywatch, we're doing that again with a new cast? Like, literally what they just said, hey, you know, the complicated, messy personal lives and crazy, daring rescues like Baywatch.
Yeah, and Mike and I were talking about it. We're like, man, another Baywatch? But I didn't realize they hadn't really rebooted it, right? There was the Baywatch Hawaii that ran from 99 to 01.
Baywatch Nights. Was there a Baywatch Nights?
There was a spinoff series with Hasselhoff called Baywatch Nights from 95 to 97. But and then there was the movie with The Rock and Zac Efron.
And this is a reboot.
Right. This one is just kind of its own thing, where it's just, which is kind of like, hey, we're just going to redo it.
Yeah.
But I'd imagine it'd be more like Hawaii Five-O, where it's like Hawaii Five-O has the same theme song and everything, but basically it's different actors, different thing.
Different scenarios, sure.
Yeah. And I mean, Baywatch is super iconic. I do wonder, though, are we reaching the tipping point with some of these reboots and... I mean,
I don't think in this case, based on the fact that what you're going there for, I'm pretty sure the
updated
count.
But these days, do you think they're still going to make it there? At the time Baywatch came out, it's like, look, we have blondes and big boobs. Oh, and David Hasselhoff's here, right?
Based on this past weekend's SNL, maybe.
Yeah, maybe.
Well, blondes with big boobs are always going to be super popular. But I'm just saying, like, it's also 2024, so you could find that in a lot of places. I don't know. It just seems like... You see some of these superhero movies or whatever, they just keep pumping them out, but it doesn't seem like they're doing as well. I don't know. I just feel like we're just going to the well, and it's like,
they go to the well.
Why not just have somebody, like, there's people in Hollywood that write shows all the time. Like, there's got to be another massive show that you could have some hotties in without just slapping Baywatch on it.
Well, that's what's funny, and I'm reading today, it was Daniel Day-Lewis, maybe, he's like, I'm officially retiring from acting. And part of the reason, as he said it, is all these different streaming services, which makes no sense to me. But the flip side of the streaming services, like you're saying, Ted, the people that are actually writing original content,
yeah,
that's the place they at least get to test it out. You know, maybe it'll be successful, maybe it won't, but I think that's the best thing. If you're a writer in Hollywood, I would think the streaming services is the best thing that's happened.
And more job opportunities.
That's what I mean. You know what I mean? There's more things to pitch. You have more people willing to listen. And again... You know, streaming services, unlike networks, you know, they'll give you a shot. But if it sucks after three episodes, they just pull it. And somehow in the world of streaming, we don't care. Nah, we gave it a shot. You know what I mean? Because we'll fill it with something else. And you go, all right, cool. It didn't work. Where network, it's like, all right, you know, we'll give you 12 episodes. And it becomes this big thing where, I don't know. I think streaming is a good thing for creativity.
Right. And I think also that's sort of, I mean, it's easy to just pick out Hollywood. Sometimes I just think that's the way, you know, since the 80s, you've gone with, like, corporate America, right?
Mm-hmm.
Like, things have, they changed the rules again. So now, basically, it's, I guess it's not technically a monopoly, but there's only a few companies doing these
things. It's not a monopoly because it's not one, right? But there's, like, three.
Correct. So it's just funny to me that now you sit around just rebooting stuff, and it's like, well, we never have this, or we never have that. It's like, well, you can't because you don't have anybody, you don't have anything new.
You don't invest in
you
it.
You might have a massive thing. You just have no ideas. You're just redoing the same stuff. I mean, look, in sports, it's easy, right?
You run it's the a new season.
You run the same offense. You're not winning games. You're going to get fired.
Yep.
And look, the Seahawks just did it, right? Brought in a much younger staff, this and that, and they said, all right, we're going to try something new. But, like, yeah, with some of this stuff, it's like, guys, like, come on. Like,
come up with something. And we know there's ideas out there, but the thing, like, with the superhero movies, I think with the success of the Avengers and Iron Man before that, they were, man, we could make a lot of money. One of the differences with those movies were actually well made, right? So now they can, what is it, the Marvels? What's the one we were just laughing about before, the three chicks? Madam Web, right? I mean, the reviews were god-awful. The only review I read of that movie that said go see it, because you will laugh out loud at how bad of a movie it is. It's not a comedy, but they said it's just such a bad movie. It's kind of entertaining, but go to the matinee so you don't spend the real money. But so the thing is, like, the Avengers do well, and then I feel like the studios just go, hey, man, just make a superhero movie. It's like, no, make a good superhero movie. When Star Wars came out, right, everyone started making sci-fi movies, and they were all terrible. You know, like, you can't just do it because someone else did it. That's like us saying, I can play football because I watched the Seahawks run this play, right? Let me take the field. I can do it. No, you can't.
Yeah, I mean, look, and that's the thing about Baywatch, too, is, like, when that aired, right, I was a kid. We watched it.
Sure.
Now, granted, the hot chicks didn't hurt, but, like, they weren't trying to be that campy and cheesy. That's just the way TV was. So it was, like, a decent show, too, that people liked.
You didn't realize it was campy and cheesy, because, like you said, that's what everything was.
Yeah. Most people who run on television don't do it in slow motion.
Right.
Yeah, right?
That's a movie.
Right, so it's like, yeah. And obviously the attractive people, male and female, right? It's not like the guys when he slouches, didn't hurt, but it's like, I don't know, like, you're just kind of running it out there. I mean, hell, look, we saw it with Top Gun, right? Top Gun had always been that movie. I love it. People talked about it. Then they came out with that second one. And I remember I told you guys after I watched it on that flight, I go, look, it is super cheesy, but it's like the right amount of cheesy.
Right.
It's pretty awesome.
It doesn't take itself too seriously.
Correct. Now I saw they're talking about doing another one, and I'm like,
Man, don't go back to the well too many times, you know?
Right, like with Top Gun, right? We had broken up with Top Gun, 30 years ago? It was great to see Top Gun.
Sure.
We're glad Top Gun.
It's a high school reunion.
Maybe Tom Cruise. Good. Maybe. It doesn't mean I want to hang out with Top Gun every weekend.
I should have never connected with you on Facebook.
Maybe Tom Cruise is the owner of a small bar, and he's an alcoholic now, and he used to be successful with, you know,
Houlihan's
or whatever the hell the name of that place was.
Cocktail and Dreams.
Exactly. But now, you know, he's that old bartender. Got an alcohol problem. And
he's bitching about Spring Breakers.
Sets a theme here.
Yeah, the bar's going to shut down because, you know, like, it doesn't have the regular customers that he once had.
Yeah, yeah, you could. Well, they made a movie called Spring Breakers. Never saw one, but... what was that? I think it was about a week ago. Thanks for giving me this one, Miles. We were talking about the booth from the final scene in The Sopranos. They were talking about they might get 60,000. It was up to 60,000 to auction it off. Well, they ended up getting $82,000 for it.
Okay, now what do you do with it? Do you put it in a restaurant? Do you make that a focal point to get people in your establishment?
That's a better idea.
Do you put this in your house?
I can't imagine a small restaurant having $82,000 to pay.
Agreed.
So I would have to think this is just a personal collection.
It's going to go to someone's house who's loaded.
Someone's house or...
And they might end up loaning it to, like, the Smithsonian or one of those kinds of things. You know, temporary display. Because if you told me it was there, as irrelevant as it is, I'd be like, I'm going to go look at the Sopranos booth. Yep, there's the booth.
Is there a TV, like, history museum?
There's got to be somewhere.
Oh, yes. It's in Chicago, and it is closed down because they are moving it. It'll reopen in 2025. So they had one location, and they just... It's basically a Hall of Fame museum.
Sure, but I mean, just all the iconic stuff, yeah.
Yeah, like, I mean, I think it's cool when you could take, like, a tour in Hollywood and the studios and see that stuff.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, hell, even the fake versions, the Universal Studios are pretty cool.
Sure.
But I don't know that I would just be like, we got to go to this museum. They have the booth from The Sopranos.
That alone would not get me there. But like you said, if it's a TV museum, like, okay, that'd be cool. Be cool if you could just take all the old sets, right? Because most of those sets are, what, about 12 by 10 or something like that? If it's a home kind of thing where this is the Family Matters living room, here's the Three's Company living room, here's this, here's that, you know, the hall of rooms.
Yeah, you could. You could have a hall of booths.
Who else? Besides
Seinfeld, they're always in a diner sitting in a booth.
Yep.
Yeah.
Friends, they said, Central Perk.
But they already had that pop up in town. Because I know a lot of people went to that.
Yeah,
I guess you're right.
Golden Girls.
I know two big famous booths that I'm out.
Brady Bunch living room.
Yeah, you don't really want to have a thing for John Wilkes Booth.
The John Wilkes Booth.
Jesus. I'm just trying to get famous booths.
Wow.
The John Wilkes.
Can you imagine like a little diner just carding something off?
No, you eat in a little plate. You eat in a balcony.
Yeah. Oh, God, yeah. It's a balcony.
In a theater. And then you just wait.
Let's see. Jamie Foxx, we all know he had a health scare last year. Now in a new comedy special, he's actually going to talk about it. So I think people will be interested in that. Basically, all he says now is just how tough it was and this and that. I think people are kind of still just like, what happened to you?
Yeah.
I mean, I'm assuming because he's such a fit guy that it's probably like a stroke or something. Like, he's so fit and goes to the doctor. Like, I can't imagine it was like a heart attack or something. Like, you feel like you would, a guy like that would have known.
But also, I'm guessing it's a stroke because he was so hush-hush about it. And a lot of times after you've had a stroke where you're struggling to speak again.
Correct.
That kind of thing. You know, just keep the press away from me. I'll figure it out.
Yeah. I was talking to somebody a couple months ago. I didn't know this person. It was like a big gathering. I started talking to them. And they, within like 1 minute, they're like, sorry, I don't always sound like this. I had a minor stroke a few months ago.
Well, actually, Sinbad, I was like, oh. Sinbad opened up for the first time a couple days ago, and he was, you know, I mean, he had a horrible last year.
Yeah, I saw that as well, right? That was the first thing I want to say he had put on social media or anything in like 2 or 3 years, probably 2 years. So, yeah. And say like we always said, house guest. Solid movie. I don't know if it holds up, but I still want Mike to watch it.
It's McDonald's.
Let's see. Like Mean Girls, the movie, the streaming premiere of Mean Girls is on Paramount Plus. It starts today.
Okay, thank you, Tim. We appreciate it. You're listening to The Men's Room.
You've probably heard about generative artificial intelligence, but are you vigilant to its exploitability? Generative AI is shaping society and transforming our daily lives. While we want to embrace the potential, we must also set the standards for responsible use and safeguard the future of our digital world. HackerOne employs over 2 million plus ethical hackers, 750 of them specializing in prompt hacking and other AI security and testing. The creative approach taken by a diverse pool of ethical hackers is the best way to discover vulnerabilities. When launching new AI deployments, let HackerOne's AI red teaming address the novel challenges of AI safety and security for your business. AI innovation can only be effective if models are tested for safety and security issues that could cause harm. Make sure your AI models and deployments can't be tricked into providing information beyond their intended use, and that security flaws can't be exploited to access confidential data or systems with HackerOne. Learn more about our AI red teaming today at HackerOne.com/AI.
Look around. You can find cars like these on AutoTrader. New cars, used cars, electric cars, maybe even flying cars. Okay, no flying cars, but as soon as they get invented, they'll be on AutoTrader. Just you wait. Auto Trader.
At Metro, get an iPhone 12 with 5G and a dual camera system for $99.99. Take amazing pictures and share them instantly. And don't put up with life's yada yada.
Yada yada.
Like photo bombers. Zoom, crop out,
yada yada,
and bye.
You don't take yada yada in life, don't take yada yada from your wireless provider. Get iPhone 12 with 5G with no activation fees and nada yada yada. Only at Metro by T-Mobile. Switch to Metro, bring your ID. This offer isn't available for customers currently at T-Mobile or that have been with Metro in the past 180 days.
The Men's Room returns with Miles and Thrill. Now, let's see what's happening in the real world.
All right, here we go. Robert Steele, 600 Venus flytraps in North Carolina, bringing a WKRP DJ to tears. Meanwhile, a woman is arrested for DUI with two 14-year-olds, who'd also had a few beers. Man stuck in airplane bathroom sees the pilot help him open the door because of a trained sex offender in Eugene, Oregon is no more. And a drunk Indiana woman lets two 12-year-olds drive her car home at 1 a.m. It is time for your headlines.
Now, it's time to hit the headlines.
Here's Mike Hawk.
At a top tournament in North Carolina, where police made an interesting bust. They got information that a couple people were doing some illegal digging at a local conservancy land and managed to track down the two at a local gas station. They placed the two under arrest and searched their bags to find their stolen goods. Upwards of 600 Venus flytraps.
That is an odd thing to steal.
It is indeed. The plant is protected in the area, and people have been known to harvest and sell the exotic plant either locally or on the black market, and the two are now facing charges.
An early native like to that one place on Earth, right?
Really, on the entire planet, just there in North Carolina?
I believe that is the case, man. That is the only spot that they grow.
I mean, I've wanted one just to be around the house just so it can kill some of the bugs around
the
house.
Go where the flies are, you know?
Yeah, exactly, right? Oh, yeah, exactly. In other news to L.A., where a car theft didn't go according to plan. Our thief spotted his targeted car, which was running without any driver in the front seat. Perfect target. He was able to get in the driver's seat of the car, but wasn't able to work any of the controls in order to actually make off with it. That's about the time that the owner of the car piped in on the communication systems and demanded that he get out of the vehicle. When he refused, police were called and arrived on the scene in short order to arrest the man. Which is more reason why the self-driving cars for the rideshare company Waymo, they're not your best target for car theft. You know, it faces charges. I saw those this weekend. They are a trip. It's friggin' weird.
You saw one actually on the road?
I saw a lot of them out there on the road. My Uber driver said that they must also be in Los Angeles, but he said that Phoenix is like the only area that they actually are. And they are everywhere.
They're driverless ones?
Yes.
I've seen them in Austin.
Oh, no kidding.
Yeah.
Well, then my driver was completely mistaken.
It must be big, flat places.
Right?
Right, for the most part.
Because, you know, we drove by one, and it's got all the bells and whistles and stuff on that, and I thought it was like a Google Maps car. So it was like, everybody smile, we're going to get on camera. He's like, actually, no, that's one of those self-driving cars. And they are wild. They move in and out of traffic. They turn in front of traffic. They're driving on the doggone freeway.
Ted's idea of... Someone breaks in, they want to drive off, the doors lock, and it drives you directly to the police station.
Exactly.
You were trying to steal me.
Thank you for choosing Waymo.
Right.
Right, that's what so worries me. You're like, you check in, it's like, you have warrants.
Right. That you didn't know about.
Damn it.
Yeah, exactly.
Come with me.
Might have to tell somebody you know not to take one of those in Portland.
Oh, yeah. We wouldn't see him again. Talk about your grandfather. He's a wanted man in the state of Oregon. Yeah.
He's joking.
No, yes, he is.
I'm not joking. No, I'm not joking.
Oh, yeah.
Look, he got a speeding ticket years ago, and he never paid it off. It's been like almost 40 years, and at this point, he owes probably $500,000. And if they catch him in the state of Oregon, Pop-Pop's gone.
He's gone. We take to the lovely world of the internet where someone shared a story of a rather uncomfortable flight. A woman was flying with her husband and their two children, aged 2 and 4, when her husband felt the call of nature and excused himself back to the back of the plane.
No, it's because they're 2 and 4. That's why his ass went to the back of the plane.
That was honestly a joke, because he seemed to be taking his time, as after more than 5 minutes, he still hadn't made his way back to his seat. And she actually said, I'm thinking he's just taking a good reprieve from the kids, right? She was just starting to get a bit concerned when a flight attendant announced that the door to the lavatory was jammed and someone was stuck inside, knowing exactly who it was. Several flight attendants attempted to free the man while still preserving the lavatory door, but after about half an hour of the man being stuck inside, the pilot made an appearance and basically gave them clearance to damage the plane to get him out.
Like, that's why they had to get the pilot, just to say, like...
Pretty much.
Yeah.
Because he kicked it from the inside while he pulled and worked the hinges from the outside.
Exactly.
If I were that guy, I'd be like, thank you, but who's flying the plane?
Right?
That's what all the...
Oh, right!
That's what all the passengers were wondering. That's all the everybody was on the plane, the same thing. Right. Like, that's the pilot.
Are
that's
we okay?
The pilot. Yeah, we're
going to
die.
We're going to call pilots because if the
My daughter dropping knowledge.
Plane crash!
Yes, plane crash. The co-pilot, baby.
Right. They didn't give him a doggone thing for that, by the way. There was no compensation at all for him being locked in there for half an hour.
Well, he probably didn't ask for any. He probably said, look, man, on the bright side, my 4 and 2-year-old, I don't know if you've been on a plane with a 4 and 2-year-old, but it's a lot.
It's a lot.
Yeah.
As long as we get there, that's all I care.
And just in case those stories left a bad taste in your mouth.
Thankfully, there's good news.
We head down to California, where a record may have been broken. The record was set in 2019 in the quiet town of Los Angeles. where a group of 252 people all gathered together wearing dinosaur costumes.
Oh, man.
This set the record for the largest gathering of people all dressed up as dinos, but now it seems that record may have been busted. A group of 1,273 people stormed Legoland, California, all having donned their favorite dinosaur costume with the idea of breaking the record. There was an attempt last year to break the record in Saskatchewan, but it is yet to be recognized by the Guinness Book. Even if it has, this latest gathering would still beat it.
Guinness ignores Canadians.
Legoland, huh?
Yeah.
Legoland.
Next. Yeah.
In the world of sports, Mariners spring training continued today, hosting the world champion Texas Rangers with a rousing score of 10-9. Mariners lost this one too. Kraken Rocks were able to get it done last night, beating the Flames in a 4-2 victory. They're right back at it again and facing the Jets in Winnipeg tonight. That game currently underway as we speak over En Route Sports. As far as the weather, we're staying dry tonight into tomorrow, expecting temperatures to dip down to freezing level tonight, warming back up to the mid-40s tomorrow. And that is it for your headlines. With that, my hot is up.
Thanks, sir. Appreciate it. Stop on the way home. Pick up the Men's Room IPA from Black Raven Brewing. Tasty and delicious. We'll see you next time for Who Sucks Less.
Yes, indeed. It's all true, but in the meantime, we'll be all about this bitch. So until next time, please do what you do best. And for Aletha's sake, stay beautiful.
The Men's Room has been taped before a live studio audience. Wardrobe and makeup provided by Mantastic Limited. This has been a presentation of the Men's Room Radio Network.
Oh, man!
A Double Flush production.
My 13-year-old acts like a puppy again. Almost overnight, she's a different dog.
Perfect poops.
When people switch their dog's food to the farmer's dog, the effects can seem like magic. But there's no magic involved. It's simply real meat and vegetables with all the nutrients dogs need instead of highly processed pellets. No tricks, just smarter, healthier pet food delivered in packs portioned for your dog. It's amazing what real food can do. Get 50% off your first order at thefarmersdog.com/nomagic.
Listening to your favorite podcast? That's smart. Earning your degree online from Southern New Hampshire University? That's really smart. With 24/7 access to coursework, no set class times, and dedicated student support, you can go to school when and where it works for you. Low online tuition means you can even do it for less. And dedicated student support means we'll be with you from day one to graduation and beyond. Join a community of learners just like you. Go to snhu.edu today to start your free application.
From executive producer Jimmy Kimmel.
What's up, team? Just two people can't launch a brand. It takes a village.
We are MMD Hollywood.
Wowee.
Which stands for medical marijuana.
Due to restrictions, we can't tell you everything about our new reality series. But what we can say is the idea behind it is fully baked. High Hopes. Streaming 4/20 on Hulu.
This episode is brought to you by Allianz Travel Insurance. Are you planning two or more trips in the next 365 days? An all-trips annual travel insurance plan can protect all your adventures for less. Get a quote at allianztravelinsurance.com.